Tonight and two ties. So game one of the Norris Division Finals, no exception from the regular season as far as these two teams going head to head.
And certainly what both teams expected. But you know, the Blues coming into this game, the Blues players after the Monday game, you know, they feel very confident. I mean, they're not loose, but they're very confident knowing that they're going to play much better tonight. They couldn't understand why they didn't come out and play quite as physical as they wanted to be. And tonight, I think we'll see a little different Blues team.
We're set to go. Ron Wilson at center, Dave Lowry on the left wing, Brett Hull on the right wing for the Blues. In front of Curtis Joseph on defense, Jeff Brown and Garth Butcher. Peter Zezel with Mark Osborne and Bill Berg for Toronto. Sylvain Lefebvre and Jamie McCowan on defense in front of 21-year-old Felix Botvin. And they drop the puck, and McCowan has it to Lefebvre. And the Leafs, Lefebvre backhands the puck in, knocked down by Butcher. It slides right to Joseph, and he pounces on the puck as Berg and Butcher look at each other eyeball to eyeball. Bill Berg, number 10 for Toronto, has been battling the flu lately and is able to go tonight. Peter Zezel always seems to be able to go against the Blues.
Well, he's playing very good hockey right now for this Toronto team. You know, he hasn't played in the playoffs in 3 years, so he missed that. And I've never seen Peter Zezel as focused as he has been lately. Not only in game situations and during the game, but even the morning skates, you know, avoiding everyone, kind of walking around with a frown on his face, and he's normally a very personable type person.
Now the faceoff outside the St. Louis blue line. Zezel against Wilson. And the puck to Lefebvre. He'll shoot it in off the arm of Butcher, and play stopped across the way. Some fencing between Lowry and Osborne, and Paul Stewart right away says, I've seen enough of that already. And just 12 seconds into the game, he sends Osborne and Lowry to the penalty box.
Well, Ken, you can already feel the intensity level of both teams at a higher level than it was in game one. And right off the opening faceoff, the puck ended up in front of the Blues bench, and Ron Wilson took a run at Lefebvre right away. And right off this next faceoff, Dave Lowry and Mark Osborne both get their sticks up, start pushing and shoving somewhat. Paul Stewart was on the other side of the ice, and he didn't hesitate at all to blow the whistle and make the first call.
Of course, in a lot of these Stanley Cup playoff games, there haven't been a lot of penalties. Consequently, the coaches, Pat Burns and Bob Berry, kind of say, well, you don't know without a lot of penalties how much the special teams are going to come into play. They didn't play that big a factor here on Monday night. The puck to center ice, and the Leafs shoot it back in offside. Of course, coming into the series, the Blues felt they had a huge advantage in terms of special teams.
And even Brett Hull felt during the game the other night. The first two periods, he said, he really had a difficult time getting going. He said his legs just didn't really feel like they were there, and he didn't have that jump that he had. He said it took until the third period and the overtime to really start feeling good. And that, again, has been the response from most of the St. Louis Blues players.
Dave Lowry and Mark Osborne each getting 2 minute high sticking minors 12 seconds into the game. The team's playing four aside here. Wilson waved out of the faceoff. Now Hull against Gilmore, and the Blues control. Brown sweeping the puck back to Butcher. Butcher and Brown, now Miller and Wilson, a couple of defensive oriented forwards for the Blues, especially Wilson, who has the puck, takes a shot, and it goes wide of the Toronto net. Dave Ellett back behind the net, bothered by Kevin Miller, tied up by Miller. Then Ellett gets loose into the corner with the puck. He's got Gilmore in front of him, gives him the puck. Glenn Anderson, who is playing tonight, is on the right wing with Gilmore over the line to Anderson, looking for Gil, then shoots, and it hits Gilmore. The puck behind the Blues net into the corner. Anderson bumps, still has the puck, tries to feed in front, it hits Basson. Then Miller to Basson, now to Brett Hedekin, the Blues rookie defenseman over the line. Long shot off the arm of Felix Potvin, and the puck sails over the glass and into the crowd, and there's a minute 9 to go, and the penalties to Dave Lowry and Mark Osborne.
And we'll see quite a bit of Bob Basson again tonight for the Blues. He mentioned yesterday morning that maybe game one was a wake-up call for his team. He was surprised the way they didn't come out and hit and play with the intensity that they had in the four-game series against the Chicago Blackhawks. And again, it's all the way down the line. The players feel that tonight they're back into it. 8 days off. It took them a while to get back into it. Had they won game one, I think it would have been a real steal to win that game for Curtis Joseph.
Now the faceoff to Felix Potvin's right. The Blues with Emerson and Shanahan. Butcher and Brown. No score, still very early, only a minute three gone. Zezel against Emerson for this faceoff. Wendell Clark, the other forward for Toronto. On defense, it's Rouse who gets the punt with McCowan. Bob Rouse, the 28-year-old veteran, up to Wendell Clark, the Leafs captain. A pass behind Zezel and Brown for the Blues. Off of Emerson to Shanahan. Shanahan didn't do a lot, really, in game number one. Shanahan falls down. Clark gets the puck, can't work in as the Blues scramble back. The team's playing 4-on-4. The puck deep in the Blues' end. And Jeff Brown with it. Neither team has had a shot on goal. Butcher for Emerson. He deflects it in. Potvin plays it up the right wing boards. Behind Clark, Rouse tied up, and Clark clears to center ice, picks the puck up, and a pass for Zezel broken up by Zombo. His feed intercepted. Here's McCowan. McCowan into the blue zone with Clark. McCowan to the net with a shot and an easy stick save for Joseph. Here's Clark with some room. Clark in front of drive. Oh, and Joseph the save. He stops Zezel on the first rebound. Zezel shoots the puck wide. The Blues get the puck. Shanahan can't get it out. McCowan keeps it in. And the Blues take over Zombo. Now Lowry and Osborne back on as Hedek and winds up. Let's a shot go again off Potvin's arm. And the puck goes into the crowd. Play stopped here in game two at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. 2:20 gone, no score, first period.
And two outstanding saves by Curtis Joseph. The first one on Wendell Clark. What happened on the play, both Blues defensemen end up behind the net. Hedekin and Zombo, and Clark comes out with the puck. He'll end up taking the first shot. A great left pad saved by Joseph. And then Peter Zezel was able to get one shot. Joseph made the save, and then he, on the rebound, shot it wide on the backhand. Boy, he looks sharp again tonight, doesn't he, Ken?
Very much so. There hasn't been a goalie any better in the NHL for a couple of months than that man, Curtis Joseph. Now the faceoff at the other end near the Leafs goal. Shanahan with Basil McRae and Brett Hull. Hedekin and Zombo on defense for the Blues. And the Leafs control the faceoff. Andrechuk gets the puck from Krzyzewski, shoots it into the far corner. There's Gilmore looking to center. He hits Janney, and Brett Hull, the Blues captain, picks up the puck. Up to the veteran McRae, now to Zombo, right wing to Janney. Janney is poke checked at the Toronto line. Andrechuk back the other way to Gilmore. Nice pass. Then Krzyzewski trying to get a shot. Krzyzewski taken down in the corner. He had the big goal, of course, in game seven of the opening round as the Leafs eliminated Detroit. Janney, a drop pass. McRae doesn't expect it. McCowan feeds ahead to Dave Andrechuk. He had six goals in that Detroit series. A nice move, a shot right on, and a rebound cleared away by Joseph. And here's Brett Hull. He can't get out. Andrechuk steals. Krzyzewski in the corner. Looks to the blue line. Lapeva shot. It hits Zombo. Rebound. Andrechuk, a drive. Oh, a great save by Joseph. And he smothers the rebound. A dazzling save by Joseph on Dave Andrechuk. No score here in Toronto. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
One hand on the stick. Hey, Tom, you're going to show? Well, we probably won't have time to run the whole thing. If you could show it when Brett Hull had it on the boards and lost it. It's back further. I don't know if we'll have time, though. Yep, yep, that's it. Dave Andrechuk made the initial play. Brett Hull has a chance to clear the puck on the boards. He has one hand on his stick. Andrechuk just lifts the stick, steals the puck, gets it back in deep. And then Andrejczuk is going to end up going to the front of the net after the nice pass, a long shot. Joseph with the save. And then there was a great chance by Andrejczuk that Joseph also made the save on.
Now back to live action. Ellett shoots the puck in. Joseph clears it up the boards. Felsner takes his man. Ellett gets the puck. And Denny Felsner, the rookie, clears to center ice to Shanahan. He fires the puck in. Leafs goalie Potvin clears around the board. Shanahan knocks the puck down, keeping it in at the point. Cantal. Then Felsner to Shanahan. Back to Felsner, and the play broken up, and here come the Leafs. Kent Manderville shoots the puck in. This is Manderville, Pearson, and Eastwood for Toronto. Pearson intercepts and centers the puck through the goal mouth. No one there for Toronto. Blues can't clear. Ellett keeps it in, and then Joseph pokes the puck away from Manderville. And out to center ice, Brendan Shanahan for the Blues. Ahead to Nelson Emerson into the corner. He'll take a shot that goes by the net, and here's Bill Berg clearing the zone for the Leafs as the two teams complete a line change. Shooting it in is Bozon. Ellett ahead now for Berg. Here's Toronto on the attack. Long shot and the save by Joseph. Blues Brown can't clear. Zezo leaves the puck, and here's Philippe Bozon ahead to Dave Lowry. He'll bounce the puck in wide of the Toronto net. Potvin clears it off the glass to Mark Osborne. Osborne up to Zezel. He's hit, feeds on the right wing to Berg. Two on one with McCowan. Brown back, Berg in front. Great poke check. What a play by Jeff Brown. Now the puck stolen by Osborne. He's pinned to the boards by Butcher. Then Zezel knocks the puck behind the net, and Brown takes over. His pass hits Gill. Then Wilson picks up the puck, feeds right wing for Bozon as the Blues work in. Bozon, a shot, and that goes just wide. The rebound to center ice. Sezel works in over the line. Two on one with Osborne. To Osborne, and he tips the puck wide. Sezel tries to center to Berg. He's slammed down, and there'll be a penalty call here against the Blues. The Maple Leafs will have the first power play chance of Game 2 of the Norris Division Finals.
Well, the Blues got caught twice giving up two-on-ones. The last time Rick Zombo was back. Now, he makes a great defensive play by going down to block the shot. But then Peter Zezel jumped on the puck, was pulled down by Ron Wilson. And Wilson will go off for the Blues. And Toronto will have the first power play chance of this game.
5:13, the time of the hooking penalty to the veteran Ron Wilson. Wilson, number 18. Bob Bassett, number 28. Figure to see a lot of playing time tonight for the Blues.
Well, the first two-on-one, Jeff Brown. What an outstanding defensive play with the poke check. His stick as Berg tries to cut right to the middle. Brown with the outstanding play.
Now Toronto sets it up on the power play. They had a power play goal here on Monday night. Side of the net looking to center, unable to. Cullen, he wheels it around near side to Ellett. Ellett on the left point, Gill on the right point. A centering effort by Cullen. Deflects off to the far right wing. Who has it? Gilmore. Who else? In deep to Cullen. Now Ellett in front. And his shot fails to beat goaltender Curtis Joseph. Here is Gilmore again for Toronto to the blue line to Gill. Near point, not to Ellett. Back to Todd Gill. Near circle for John Cullen. He has trouble with a bouncing puck. Into the corner to Dave Andrejczuk. Now this is Cullen, who was used sparingly in game one. To Andrejczuk, side of the net. Cullen in front of shot. The save. Oh, Gilmore can't get a handle on the puck and the rebound as he was well covered. The Blues are shorthanded. No score first period. Gilmore feeds the puck to Todd Gill. Right point. He fakes a shot. Not a Dave Ellett. Back to Gill. One-timer. The save. And the rebound cleared away by the Blues. And Joseph has been tested early. Toronto's already had 9 shots on goal. Here they come again. 48 seconds to go on the Toronto power play. And Gilmore stopped at point-blank range by Joseph after a fine setup by John Cullen, who feeds to the near corner to Dave Andrejczuk. Andrejczuk in the circle to the blue line to Ellett. Ellett ahead for Andrejczuk. Great long reach, then a poke check by Lowry. And Kevin Miller shoots the puck the length of the ice for the Blues.
Boy, a couple of great saves, especially the one on Doug Gilmore. Curtis Joseph holding the Blues in the game at this point.
Here's Toronto. Ellett, 18 seconds to go on the power play to Zezel. Over to McCowan, a drive. And save, rebound in front. Basson gets the puck, hit by Clark. He can't clear. Borshevsky, right point to Ellett. Now to Nikolai Borshevsky, into the corner to Peter Zezel. Borshevsky again to Ellen. Over near side, McCowan, the penalty over to Borshevsky. Shot right on, a save. And Zezel is stopped again by Curtis Joseph. And the Blues goaltender has been fabulous here in the first period. There's no score at Maple Leaf Gardens. And this is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Coming back with something, Tom. If you can show the Bastin made a great defensive play on Gilmore the first time when he was wide open on the side, and then after that Gilmore had that great chance. Which one is this you're showing first, Tom? How's it? Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs had great puck control on their power play, moving the puck around. A great chance by Cullen. Joseph made the save, and then Bob Bassett, 28 for the Blues, came back as Doug Gilmore had a wide open net, but an outstanding defensive play. And then right at the end of the power play, Peter Zezel in front is able to get the rebound, didn't get a lot on the shot, and Curtis Joseph was able to cover up.
Boy, Toronto really taking it to the Blues. The Leafs have outshot the Blues 13-1 here in the first 7 minutes and 18 seconds of game two. And the Leafs had five shots on that power play. Toronto, of course, has not done real well on the power play in the playoffs. Blues trying to get the puck out, having trouble. Manderville to Pearson. He's got Eastwood in front, and the pass hits Joseph and is deflected away. The puck cleared out by Wilson. Leafs control again. Rouse shoots the puck in. Brown shoots it out, and here is Lefebvre. Sylvain Lefebvre whistles the puck in. And the Blues back for it. Bozon lets it go, but Manderville trying to make a play to Lefebvre. He steps into a shot. Great save. And Manderville's shot goes wide as the net comes loose. Young Rob Pearson, the 22-year-old Leaf winger, ended up in the net. And Paul Stewart is indicating that the faceoff will come outside the St. Louis blue line.
Well, Bob Barry not real happy on the Blues bench right now. One change that he has made in this game thus far is that he hasn't rotated his lines and changed up his lines like he did in game number one. One faceoff that was deep in Toronto's zone, Gilmore's line was facing off against Janney. Janney's line stayed on the ice. That's what we've seen here in the early going. Bobby trying to get his team to have more flow and more consistency in their game, but thus far it's been all Toronto.
The Leafs now out shooting the Blues 15-1. Anderson and Andrechuk are the wings. Gilmore at center for Toronto. And the puck shot in by Gill, who's on defense for the Leafs with McCowan. This is a big scoring line, of course, for Toronto. Hull on the ice for the Blues. Far left wing pass. Bozon over the line. Slap shot off the glove. A puck there wide of the net. Andrechuk at his own end. Bothered by Wilson. Still has the puck. A good move around Bozon. Another around Hull. And he'll flip the puck ahead to the Blues defense. Hedekin gloves it down, and Wilson plays it, and the whistle stops because of the hand pass. No score here in the first period, and Toronto is simply on fire, and that power play really helped them, and that man, Felix Potvin, has not had much to do.
Now, Pat Burns was saying this morning that he was very impressed with the way Potvin played in the game the other night. He says it's actually probably more difficult for a goaltender that is not facing quite as many scoring chances as Curtis Joseph did to keep his concentration, and that's one thing Potvin did in game one.
Face off outside the St. Louis blue line, and the Blues control. Dave McElwain, who did not play in game one, centering a line for Toronto. Janney works in. Janney trying to feed in front of the hole. Shot, he scores! Brad Hull from Craig Janney. Hull scores to give the Blues a 1-0 lead. Brett Hall, who does it time and time again for the Blues, scores here at 8:30 of the first period.
Well, what a play by Janney controlling the puck. Now Jamie McCowan is with Janney all the way, and Janney's able to just with one hand get the pass to Hall, who is right in the slot, and the quick shot beats Potvin. Now Hall from about 15 feet out, and that is one place where the Blues got very few shots in game number one. But what a play by Janney, using strength in those great hands to set up Brett Hall for the goal.
Craig Janney with 7 playoff points now in 6 games, and Hall has a half dozen goals in as many playoff games as the Blues shoot the puck in. Trying to get it out, Gilly can't. Wilson a shot, it hits McCowan and goes behind the Toronto net. The Blues outshot early 15-2 on their third shot on goal score to take the lead, and play stopped as the puck goes out of play.
And this morning, Brett Hall was saying he wasn't feeling very well. He thought he felt the flu or a cold or something coming on, but he sure feels better at this point. Janney with an outstanding play, and one hand on the stick, the quick shot by Hall, and Todd Gill was skating right in front of Potvin, who may have been screened on the play somewhat by Gill and Philippe Bozon, but boy, he didn't waste much time getting that shot off after the perfect feed from Janney.
8:30, the time of the goal. Hall number 6 from Janney and Zombo. Faceoff won by Shanahan. Back to Zombo, and a shot hits a skate into the far corner. Shanahan out hustles Rouse. Here is Emerson, a drive wide of the Toronto net. At the right point, trying to keep the puck in. Zombo, he's unable to, shooting it in offside, and that stops play. And Blues fans, this break in the action is a good time for you to break open an ice cold Budweiser and enjoy that fresh, pure, natural taste. Budweiser, proud to be your Bud.
Now, Ken, I mentioned the Blues getting that shot on the goal by Brett Hall from 15 to 20 feet out. That's something they didn't do in game one. Most of their good scoring chances came from right around the crease. Now, Potvin is always back in his net, but similar to Curtis Joseph, he has great reflexes. And those shots that are close in, the Blues don't have an angle, and Potvin was able to come up with those saves in game number one.
Rouse shoots it in from inside the center, and Kintal touches the puck ahead of Clark, and an icing call against Toronto.
Now, Wendell Clark was mentioning yesterday that in the first two games against Detroit, Detroit won both those games, scoring 6 goals in each. But Wendell Clark said his team came out and tried to play too physical in the first two games. They were going out of their way to try and play physical and trying to come up with hits, and they were pulling themselves out of position. And when you do that against a team like Detroit with all their firepower, they were taking advantage of that, and that was one of the big reasons why Toronto lost the first two games of that series. He said they're playing with much more control now.
The faceoff to Potvin's right, the puck into the corner. Gilmore all over Janney. Janney battling along the boards, kicks the puck behind the net. Bozon there, he's tied up by Rouse, and Paul Stewart stops play. 10:38 to go, first period, 1-0 Blues. Let's pause 5 seconds for station identification. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
It's amazing how quickly things can change. At one point, the Maple Leafs had outshot the Blues 15-1. Curtis Joseph had come up with outstanding saves for the Blues, but the Blues score the first goal.
Here's Janney into the corner for Brett Hall, behind the net to Bozon. Bozon looking to center, hits the back of the net, and Gilmore picks up the puck deep in his own end. He moves out to center ice, over the red line, into the Blues zone, but the pass puts Gilmore offside. He didn't get the puck over the blue line with him, and it is offside Toronto. Well, Doug Gilmore in game one, and it was very warm inside Maple Leaf Gardens, lost 7 pounds, and he only goes about, what, 164, 165?
Yeah, he was down into the 150s, and, well, you look at him, and you even have trouble believing he weighs that much, but what he does to try and keep up his strength is he eats a lot of pasta, and he eats that pasta for the carbohydrates, and he eats it every 1 or 2 hours. Doesn't eat a lot, but just continually feeds his body full of pasta, and that seems to be giving him all the energy. He's got a lot of it.
My kind of guy, Mr. Nutrition. Love that plain pasta, huh? Here's the faceoff. Blues control at their own line. Jeff Brown over the red line. Now to Miller. Miller over the line with Bassett and Rich Sutter. Here's Bassett looking in front. And the pass for Rich Sutter deflects off the glass behind the net. Miller centers. And Bozon can't make a play. Now Toronto. Rob Pearson out to center ice. Backhands the puck in. It deflects near the Blues goal. And Brown takes over, picking up speed. He feeds off the boards to Rich Sutter. Leaves the puck for Miller. He's slowed up by Pearson. And Butcher drives the puck in for St. Louis. Kevin Miller flips it behind the Toronto net. Ellett and Basson collide. Good move by Ellett to take possession. Ellett a right wing pass to Pearson. Pearson works to the St. Louis line. Ellett goes to the net with Manderville. And neither attempt works for Pearson. He can't get the puck in front. He's taken down by Brown. Manderville with a loose puck. Checked along the boards. Then Felsner a pass that fails to clear the zone. And here's Lefebvre for Toronto. Backhanding the puck behind the Blues net. Eastwood centers, but it hits Brown. Now Pearson behind the goal for Eastwood. Tied up by Basson. And Denny Felsner has the punt for the Blues. Both teams are changing. First gear throw, Denny Felsner. In front of the Toronto bench, Pearson is injured. He's down on the ice. And now referee Paul Stewart stops play. Both teams were changing. Felsner breaking into the Toronto end, and all of a sudden the crowd reacts and Pearson is injured on the ice.
And I didn't see what happened on the play, but Shanahan was pointing over towards Pearson after the whistle had already gone. Now Pearson had a concussion in the first series against Detroit. Seems to have the wind knocked out of him right now. He's getting up on his own power right in front of the Toronto bench and going to the bench.
Games 3 and 4 of this Norris Division Final Series will be at the arena in St. Louis Friday night at 7:30. Sunday at noon, both games are sold out. Friday night in St. Louis, Sunday afternoon, and if game 5 is necessary, and certainly the Blues hope it will be, it'll be back here next Tuesday night, May the 11th. Faceoff in the Toronto zone. Shanahan gets the draw back to Quintal. He'll let it go, and a blocker save by Potvin. Barron slides the puck behind the Toronto net. Lefebvre clears it up the board. Berg is checked by Quintal. There'll be a penalty. Stefan Quintal will pick up a 2-minute penalty for interference. 1-0, the Blues lead it on a Brett Hull goal. And this is St. Louis Blues hockey.
That coming back, Tom? Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs will get their second power play chance of this game as Stefan Quintal hits Bill Berg from behind. That's an interference call by referee Paul Stewart. Boy, Toronto's power play that first time, very, very effective, controlling the puck. They tried to make a lot of plays around the Blues net. Curtis Joseph came up with some great saves, and when the plays weren't there, they'd throw the puck back to the point for the shot from the defense.
Toronto was 1-for-4 on their power play in the opening game. In their 8 playoff games, though, they've been successful with a man advantage only 13% of the time. The Leafs power play 5-for-38. Obviously not very good. Here's Gill ahead to Andrechuk. He'll shoot the puck in for Toronto. Hedekin back. Hedekin on with Zombo, Miller, and Wilson. Leafs get the puck. Andrechuk shoots on. Joseph makes the save. Andrechuk wanted in the worst way after he let the shot go to let his arms go in the air. That's how he had that feeling. He says, that's where I score from. But you don't do it that often against that man, Curtis Joseph.
Well, he let the shot go quick. Now, behind the net, Hedekin lost the puck. Cullen picks it up, and he's got great hands. The perfect pass to Andrychuk. The quick shot, but Curtis Joseph, again, boy, he's right there. He gets those legs together. You're right, Andrychuk had his arms about halfway up, waiting to see the puck in the back of the net, but it was never there.
Yeah, then he took the old, oh, I'm just doing that to miss the net here. He wanted to just take a last peek before he let both arms into the air. Now the faceoff to Joseph's right. A minute 37 to go in the Toronto power play. Hedekin gets the puck, shoots it around the boards, off the glass, and it goes into the crowd. The Blues have the only goal here in the first period. It came 8 minutes and 30 seconds in. Brett Hull from Craig Janney and Rick Zombo. It was the Blues' third shot of the game. By that time, Toronto had already had 13 shots on goal. St. Louis Blues hockey is brought to you by the Discover Card. It pays to discover the card that pays you back.
Well, we mentioned Dave Andrychuk with that great chance. He's the player the Blues have to watch. He's one of only five NHL players in the history of the NHL to score 30 or more power play goals in the season. Finished this season with 32.
Blues shoot the puck the length of the ice. Toronto got the man they wanted, the scorer, Dave Andrychuk. And, of course, John Muckler in Buffalo got the man he wanted, goaltender Grant Fuhr. Here's Todd Gill. He'll shoot the puck in. One linesman, one ice in. The other says no, and here's Brent Hedekin smashing the puck off the glass, and Gill at his own line for Toronto. Ahead to Ellick. Ellick works in. Now to Cullen. John Cullen into the corner. Playing the puck back to the point, not sharply enough. Then Lowry gives the puck away, but Ellick loses it, and here is Ron Wilson. 50 seconds until Kintal is back, and the puck stolen from Wilson by Gilmore, of course. Now Gill for Toronto. He'll fire the puck in. Joseph able to stop it behind the net. The puck shot around the boards, not out by Brown. Here's Kevin Miller, and he shoots it the length of the ice.
I mean, Curtis Joseph has been so good that Toronto shot the puck in around the glass. He came out of his net and actually caught it with his glove along the glass.
24 seconds to go in the Leafs' power play. They trail the Blues 1-0 here in the first period. Doug Gilmore over the line. Drop pass for Jamie McCowan. McCowan with the puck. Now on the boards to Cullen. Back to McCowan. Now near circle, John Cullen. A shot in front for Gilmore. He shoots right on the goal line. The light goes on, but it looked like Joseph had the puck covered on the goal line, and certainly referee Paul Stewart was right there. The red light went on. Stewart gave absolutely no indication that he felt that the puck went over the line, but what a shot, really more of a pass over to Doug Gilmore, who was open at the right side of the net.
Well, I'm not sure the Blues are going to come out on the strong end of this one. To me, it looked like the puck may have been behind Curtis Joseph. You mentioned John Cullen. He made the perfect pass across. It was a hard pass. Gilmore had trouble handling it. When he finally did get the shot off, Joseph was able to get a piece of it. McCowan started the play on the point. Now Cullen kind of fakes the shot, and the hard pass goes over to Gilmore, who stopped it with his skate and then got one shot off, was able to get the rebound, and hits Joseph in the right leg. And then he dives in there, and the puck is hard to see, but it looked like he missed it the first time with his catching glove. Paul Stewart was right there, and the angle we had, you couldn't tell. But Gilmore was able to get his own rebound, and that angle we saw right there, the puck is clearly in.
Stewart was blocked out a little bit by the post. The goal judge and the minor officials are from out of town, put the red light on right there.
Now Garth Butcher tries to come back and help out. Gilmore got the one shot off, the second shot off. That actually would have been wide, but it glanced off the right leg of Curtis Joseph and started rolling towards the goal line. Garth Butcher is coming back in the play. Now from this angle, we won't be able to tell it's in, but Butcher is there, and he ends up coming back to help out, to try and help out. Referee Paul Stewart at the time is waving it off. And from behind the net, we get another view. It's, again, hard to see from that angle. But yep. The other angle, I believe, Ken, that we had from directly in front of the goal, to me, showed the puck was in the net.
The off-ice officials, by the way, are from Ottawa. Here's the shot that shows that maybe the puck went over the goal line completely. It looks like it did, but again, you wonder, is that possibly a look at Garth Butcher's stick, the tape on his stick, and the officials giving it many a hard look here before they make a decision.
Well, the puck was on edge, and Butcher did a heck of a job of confusing the situation for everyone, including us. But that puck was rolling slow, and I thought the first time I saw it, it looked like it was in. The last time I see it, now I'm not so sure it actually crossed the line. And of course, it has to cross the entire line. And by the noise of the crowd here, you know what happened. They just credited Toronto with a power play goal.
Doug Gilmore, the Stanley Cup playoffs leading scorer, has tackled one.
Number 93, Doug Gilmore. This number 19, John Cullen.
Well, Gilmore made such a
and
great play. He's an outstanding
McCown.
Athlete. That
time
hard pass from John Cullen. Gilmore knew he couldn't get his stick on,
John
so with his
Cullen.
Right foot, he
Jamie
ends up
McCown.
Stopping
time
the puck with his right foot and then trying to regain control. One shot, then the other one as Jeff Brown comes over. And the puck lancing off the right leg of Curtis Joseph and going in. Paul Stewart at the time didn't think the puck was in. He waved it off. But the replay credits Toronto with a power play goal.
13:09, the time of the goal, the fifth for Doug Gilmore. Cullen and McCowan assist. Gilmore now leading all scorers in the playoffs. In 9 games, he has 5 goals, 9 assists, 14 points. And the Leafs with a puck in their own end can't get it out. Hedekin, a wrist shot, and that goes wide. The puck in the Toronto end, tipped up by Andrechuk, ahead for Gilmore, 3 Blues back. Anderson trails, gets a pass, gets a shot right on, and a pad save by Joseph. And Zombo gets the puck ahead to Bozon, near wing to Hall, who has the Blues goal. It's tied at 1. Hall crunched, spun around by Rouse and Lefebvre, and the Leafs, Gilmore with a puck, and he clears it out. There's quite a bit of low-level fog over the ice here in the first period at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. It is very, very warm in here. It wasn't all that warm outside today, probably in the 60s, but very warm inside as the puck is shot in by Zombo. Rouse gets it out off the skate of Zezel. Barron shoots it back in for the Blues. Under 6 minutes to go in the first period. The Blues and the Leafs are tied at 1 here in game 2 of the Norris Division Finals. Shanahan to Janney in front. Horkintol, and the puck batted away and cleared down the ice by Toronto. Back to play at Murray Barron, a whistle and an icing call against the Leafs, who, by the way, have outshot the Blues 19-4 here in the first period.
And they had 15 shots in the first 7.5 minutes of this first period. Can you mention the fog, the low-lying fog in the building here? Well, just before game time, about 1.5 hours before game time, there was a heavy downpour here in Toronto, so you could just feel the humidity increase in this building. And again, it is extremely warm in Maple Leaf Gardens. Meanwhile, Brett Hull with a good chance, and Sylvain Lefebvre, a good defensive play, helped out by Bob Rouse on the play to prevent Brett Hull from getting a shot.
Now the faceoff to the left of the Toronto net. Janney against Zezel. 5:37 to go in the first period. Ellett gets the puck for Toronto. Here come the Leafs, 4-on-3. Ellett rifles the puck in, out to Berg. He lets it go to Osborne in front of backhand shot, and Joseph the save. And behind the play, Emerson takes down Peter Zezel. And Nelson Emerson of the Blues will go off. And the Leafs are having quite a period. They're getting a good jump on the Blues at almost every turn, and the Blues have to feel fortunate to be tied in this hockey game.
Yeah, one of the problems when you look at the shots, 20 shots on goal, is Toronto has had 2 power plays and 8 shots on those 2 power plays. Emerson was coming back into play. Osborne gets the initial shot off that Curtis Joseph makes a save on, but in the background is Nelson Emerson, number 7, who goes off for tripping. Emerson coming back, trying to defend on Peter Zezel, and he pulls Zezel down. And the Leafs will have their 3rd power play of this first period.
14:37, the time of Emerson's tripping penalty. Toronto 1-for-2 on the power play. Wilson wins the draw from Gilmore. For Blues, Brown gets the puck and shoots at the length of the ice. Back for it is Gill, pursued by Kevin Miller. Bothered by Miller. Miller on with Wilson, Butcher, and Brown for the Blues. And Toronto's Doug Gilmore with a puck. Leaves it behind his net for Ellis. Toronto has outshot the Blues now 20-4. Remember, in the double overtime game here Monday night, Toronto had 64 shots on goal, and now the Leafs are offside at the St. Louis blue line with 1:31 to go in the Toronto power play.
Now, we talked about the fog here in Toronto. It's all the way down near ice level here. And it is humid in here, isn't it, Ken? I mean, we're lucky tonight. We've got a couple of fans up here where we're stationed to help keep us a little cooler than in game one. But it's very warm here in this building.
Our station is about as high as you can get in Maple Leaf Gardens. There's not another human as high as we are in this facility. We have a great bird's eye view of the ice. Here's Gilmore in the corner. Runs into traffic. Zombo slides the puck around the boards. Ellett can't keep it in. Rich Sutter steals it. A man back. It's Gil. And the Rich Sutter drive well wide all the way out to Gilmore at the red line. His pass to Ellett. Now to Cullen over the line. Toronto to Dave Ellett. A drive, and Joseph makes the save on Dave Ellett from the near left circle. And Curtis Joseph holds on to stop play.
Well, the way that play started, Richie Sutter had a chance shorthanded. And as he brought it down the right-hand boards, he'll end up taking the shot that misses the net. So now Sutter is out of the play, and that allows Toronto to regain control of the puck. It's Gilmore. Hedekin pinches up on the play, and Toronto comes back 3-on-2 with Ellett with the quick shot from the left faceoff dot that Curtis Joseph makes the save on.
1:04 to go in the Nelson Emerson penalty. The faceoff to Joseph's right. Shanahan and Zezel. The puck comes to Brown. He can't clear it out. Jamie McCowan keeps it in. Over to the right point. Gilmore back now to McCowan. Near side to Cullen. In the corner to Andrichuk. Now Cullen with it. He's hit by Butcher. Gets the puck back to McCowan. Then Cullen over to Gilmore. He'll play it to Zezel. Out of the reach of Andrichuk behind the net. Now John Cullen in the corner has the puck stripped away by Butcher. And he backhands it out. Back forward is Todd Gill. It's 1-1. Under 4 minutes to go in the first period of game two. Toronto won the first game in double overtime, 2-1. Here's McCowan ahead to Cullen. Cullen working in, stops on the left wing boards, feeds in front, and intercepting and starting out Jeff Brown. The Blues shorthanded, long shot, the save, and Miller has the puck poked away by McCowan, and Gilmore leaves the rush for Toronto, trailed by Zezel, Andrichuk, and Borshevsky. Borshevsky behind the net to Gilmore in front for Andrichuk. He can't get a shot. The puck poked away by Joseph and cleared out by the Blues. The penalty over. And Emerson races up the right wing. Looks in front for Miller or Barron. To Barron. Backhand shot. And that's blocked. And a fine defensive play by Gilmore. Andrichuk clears the puck out of his end for Toronto. And both teams are changing. Here's Stefan Quintal at neutral ice to Hall, who fakes a shot, trying to work in, and he can't get around Lefebvre. Toronto trying to clear, they do. Borshevsky, a 2-on-0 with Clark. Borshevsky to Clark. His backhand shot, and it goes wide as Quintal got back to bother Wendell Clark. Lefebvre can't keep the puck in, a race for it, and Hall beaten to it by Mike Eastwood. Now a battle along the near boards, the puck loose, Janney gets it. Janney to Bozon. He can't control. And Rouse shoots the puck into the St. Louis end. They'll wave off icing. 2.5 minutes to go in the first period. Clark runs Zombo behind the net. This is Janney through center ice. Janney trying to get around a man. Does works in a pass for Hall. And it goes between the blade of his stick and his skate. Out to center ice. And Brown rifles the puck back in for the Blues. Now Todd Gill for Toronto. Boy, what a move by Janney. But he just couldn't quite put the puck on the stick of Brett Hull. Blues at center ice. Shanahan knocked off the puck. Here's Rick Zombo flipping it ahead. At the defense for Toronto, Gill off the far boards to Clark with Pearson and McElwain into the blue zone. Wendell Clark, and a pass deflects into the corner. Picked up by Pearson. His shot right on the save. McElwain, and he's robbed on a rebound attempt. And the Blues, Felsner one-hands the puck up to the red line offside. The Blues offside at center ice. 1-1 the score. 1:41 remaining in the first period. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Oh. Curtis, you better fill up that water bottle again, big boy. Had another busy night. Who was that on? Was that on Todd Gill, 23? Okay. Yeah. No. Okay, it was on Pearson. It was the forward. See, Gill's there and Pearson's there.
A great move by Craig Janney for the Blues as he ends up actually beating two Toronto players, Todd Gill and Rob Pearson, and goes in all alone but tries to set up Brett Hull. The puck is a little bit behind him and goes through his legs, and Toronto came back the other way.
Now the puck slides to the Blues net and Butcher has it. Butcher and Brown on defense. Brown gets the puck, looks to the near right wing, the cross ice pass by Basson, who runs into Ellett. Rich Sutter after the puck, and Rouse controls for Toronto. Driving it around the boards off Miller, kept in by Basson. He shoots the puck behind the Toronto net. Rich Sutter looking to center, leaves the puck behind the goal. It goes into the far corner for Basson. He's checked by Osborne. Miller's there with Rich Sutter. The puck deflects over the glass into the crowd, and the action stopped with 1:12 remaining. In the first period, Brett Hull scored his sixth playoff goal at 8:30 for the Blues. And on a power play, Gilmore's fifth playoff goal tied it for Toronto. That was at 13:09.
Now with 1:12 to go in this first period, you have to look at the goaltenders in this game. Curtis Joseph has been the difference in this game thus far, stopping 22 of 23 Toronto shots. And a lot of those shots, Ken, have been wonderful scoring opportunities where Joseph has had to go from one post to the other and make fabulous saves.
Toronto without Bob McGill, Drake Barahowski. Mike Foligno played game one, sitting out tonight. Daryl Shannon, Dmitry Mironov, Mike Krushelnicki, and Ken Baumgartner sitting this one out for Toronto. Glenn Anderson shoots the puck out of his own end, and Zombo darts back for it. Zombo on defense with Hedekin. Up the middle for Hull, the puck deflects away, and McCowan shoots it back in for Toronto with under a minute to go in the first period. Hull has the puck. He is on with Wilson and Lowry. Brett shoots the puck in. Lowry slowed up trying to get there, finally runs into Lefebvre, and Gilmore works out a nice flip pass to Andrechuk. Andrechuk into the blue zone, drops it for Gilmore, in front for Anderson, but he's tied up by Zombo. Now Dave Lowry at his own line, up to Ron Wilson. Wilson right wing pass for Brown up from the defense, and he'll slide the puck back behind the Toronto net. Lefebvre clears it into the corner, bad hop. Wilson takes a shot, puck kind of left loose, and a drive by Wilson, stopped by Potvin. And then Wilson and McCowan do some shoving right in front of the Toronto goal. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Why? It's our fault. No. Joe Micheletti, Ken Wilson, and Bruce Affleck back at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. 22.2 seconds to go in this first period. This game tied up at one goal apiece.
Brett Hull getting in a very, very heated discussion with referee Paul Stewart over a line change by the Blues. They were trying to make some personnel changes when Paul Stewart thought that as the visiting team they had made their last change, and I don't know that I've often seen Brett as irate as he was there.
Well, you know, in the first 5 minutes of this game, Brett Hull was having a conversation with Paul Stewart, and Paul Stewart was pointing to the bench, and Brett Hull was trying to explain to him that they weren't getting enough time to make the changes, and it's getting even more heated up at this point.
Now Zezel against Janney. Janney wins the draw. Back to Brown. Right point, Butcher. And the shot into the corner off Berg. Here's Shanahan losing the puck. Berg gets it and clears it out for Toronto. 10 seconds to go in the period. Brown across the ice. Lefebvre takes over for the Leafs. It's 1-1. He shoots the puck ahead. Janney has it. Long shot. And the save by Potvin. Here's Emerson centering. And that's the end of the first period. Toronto outshoots the Blues 23-8. Potvin not tested that much at the other end. Curtis Joseph, just a typical period. The scoring, Brett Hull at 8:30. Doug Gilmore, a power play goal at 13:09. So after 20 minutes in game two of the Norris Division Finals, the Blues and the Leafs are tied at one. Coming up during this intermission, Bruce Affleck will visit with Toronto center Peter Zezel. Stay tuned for that. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. Hall has scored for the Blues. Doug set up Mark Osborne, and that's a good a save as Joseph has made tonight. A brilliant save with 7:30 to go. Now Janney works in with Emerson in front of Emerson. He can't get a good shot. Puck knocked away by Potvin, and Osborne clears the puck out for Toronto to McCowan. 2-on-1 with Berg. Now Janney back. McCowan a shot and he misses the mark. Here's Bill Berg, run to the boards by Barron and worked over and hit by Shanahan. Then Janney starts up ice with Emerson. Three Leafs are back. Here is Emerson weaving at center ice, looking to set things up. Joined now by Shanahan. And finally, the Blues are going to change players as Potvin makes the save on Emerson's drive. 6:52 to go in the third period. Leafs shoot the puck all the way back to Curtis Joseph, and Kevin Miller picks it up. Miller in his own end, ahead of the red line. Bassan doesn't touch the puck. Then he does, and they blow the play dead. It's offside St. Louis. The pass from inside the Blues line out over the checkered center red line.
Well, what a save by Curtis Joseph. He may have saved the game for the Blues on the last save on Mark Osborne. And it was an innocent-looking play with Toronto just dumping the puck around the net. Peter Zezel gets there first, feeds Osborne, who is all alone in front. He made the save and then ran into Joseph pretty heavily in front. Janney is there. He leaves the front of the net. Boy, what an outstanding right pad save by Curtis Joseph before being run into by Mark Osborne.
In the double overtime Toronto victory in game one, the Leafs had 64 shots on goal. The most shots ever by a Leafs team in a playoff game. And tonight, they have had 41 shots on goal. The Blues have had 25. The puck deep in the Blue zone. With just over 6 minutes to go in regulation play, tied at one. Blues have trouble. Then Hedekin gets the puck up to Miller. Near right wing to Rich Sutter. He'll shoot it in. Miller after it with Lefebvre. Lefebvre chops it away. Anderson chops it over to the near side and out to center ice. Clark off the boards, out of the reach of McIlwain. Nice move by Zombo. Then his pass intercepted by Glenn Anderson. Anderson ahead for McIlwain. It's offside. The Leafs are offside at the St. Louis blue line. Well, fans, don't go anywhere. There's a lot of action left. If you're watching in St. Louis or around the country on ESPN, sit back and open an ice-cold Budweiser for that fresh, pure, natural taste that only comes from the king of beers.
Well, we had a chance to take a look at Wendell Clark, and when you talk about a player that's gone through a career of many, many injuries, it's been Wendell Clark. And even now, on a daily basis, mostly game days, he's trying to get away from that daily treatment, but he still gets acupuncture on his back. He's had a horrible back for the last 3 or 4 years, and here's a guy who's only 26 years old and yet has had very, very serious physical problems.
Leafs control in their own end. Ellard with a puck. Clears to center ice. Borshevsky can't knock it down. Hedekin gets the puck. Just coming off the bench. Replacing Barron. Near side now to Kintal. Out of his own zone. To the red line. He shoots it in. Wide of the Leafs net. Here's Bozon. Fanning. Wilson trying to keep it in. And taking over is Gilmore. Ahead to Ellett. Ellett out of the St. Louis line. Ellett in the slot. A shot. That deflects wide. And here's Brett Hull clearing the puck around the boards out to center ice. McCollin for Toronto. His pass tipped ahead by Ellett, and Hull has the puck. He leaves it near side for Zombo. His pass hits a skate. Hedekin knocks the puck down with a high stick, and referee Paul Stewart stops play. This is the second time that these two teams have met in the Norris Division Finals. The last time was 1986, and in 7 games, the Blues eliminated Toronto, and Doug Gilmore, with 5 goals, starred for the Blues. And of course, he's starring this year for Toronto. The Blues went on in 86 to lose in the Campbell Conference Championship Series to Calgary in 7 games.
And Cliff Fletcher was the general manager in Calgary and president of that Calgary team back in 1986. And in a lot of ways, these two teams pretty similar, with Bob Barry coaching one team, Pat Burns the other, both defensive-minded teams.
From center ice, Rouse winds up, smashes the puck in. 5:12 to go in the third, and the play is offside. Toronto.
And there's no question that Paul Stewart is letting these two teams play. We've seen some tripping, holding, roughing, that type of thing. And as long as it's been away from the play, referee Paul Stewart is not calling anything. He's going to let these players decide the outcome of this game.
We just had a look at Steve Stavro, the chairman of the board and chief executive officer of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Things are cooking up here in Toronto again with the Maple Leafs. Boy, are they excited after a 7-game overtime elimination of the Detroit Red Wings. And of course, Toronto has not seen a lot of winning hockey in recent years. And boy, they are excited up here in Canada. Kintal fires the puck in for the Blues. Potvin plays it around far side. Janney trying to intercept, does. Now to Shanahan in the slot to Emerson. Left point to Barron, a drive, and that's blocked by Osborne, but Barron recovers to play the puck at his own line. 4:48 to go. A pass intercepted by Zezel. 1-1 the score. Third period. Zezel inside the St. Louis line. Backhand drive knocked down by Barron. Backhander by Zezel. Deflected wide. Zezel comes in front. Again, now to his forehand, a shot, and Joseph, another save on Peter Zezel, who's been outstanding in both games. A long pass ahead out of the reach of Emerson, and Rouse circles his net for the Maple Leafs as both teams change. Up to Zezel at the red line. He'll shoot the puck in for Toronto. There's 4:15 to go in regulation time. The Blues and the Leafs tied at 1, as they were at this stage in game 1 on Monday night. This is Jeff Brown. Brown drops the puck to Miller, then he's poke checked. Brown gets it back. Brown, a pass, goes right to the goal, kicked out by Potvin. And Kevin Miller in the near corner, a pass behind the net to Basson. This is the Blues checking line to Miller. Deflection in the air, and a grab by Potvin. And he holds on to stop play. And there's 3:54 to go in regulation time. The Blues and the Leafs are tied at 1. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Getting close.
Big guy, coast to coast. People are watching me everywhere tonight. Whoa!
How about South Florida?
Everybody.
He's played Janney and Hull a lot more tonight, hasn't he? I mean, he hasn't worried much about the about matchups tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Ken Wilson along with Joe Micheletti and Bruce Affleck at historic Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. Under 4 minutes to go in regulation play. Shots on goal favoring the Leafs 42-26, tied at one. Hall scored for the Blues in the first period. He has 6 goals in as many playoff games. Gilmore tied it with a power play goal for Toronto. Leafs shoot the puck in. Gilmore has a shot down. Zombo leaves it for Hedekin and loses it. Gilmore centers. Andrejczyk, a shot blocked. Oh, baby, what a save on Andrejczyk. And the Blues clear the puck down the ice. Pellett back for it with 3.5 to go in the third. A long pass too far. Zombo ahead to Hall. Now to Wilson. In over the line. He tips the puck ahead. And Nikolai Borchevsky picks it up and leaves it for Andrejczyk, who was just robbed by Curtis Joseph. Back to Borchevsky. He's bumped by Zombo. Wilson trying to clear the puck out. Battling along the boards with Andrejczyk. And finally Shanahan takes over for St. Louis. Shanahan with Emerson. Shanahan, a couple of dazzling moves. Now gives the puck to Emerson. Blues changing. A shot stopped that time by Potvin. Here's Emerson again. Fanning checked along the boards in the Toronto end. Then Janney. Bumped by McCowan. The puck left. Shanahan has it. Working to the slot. Turns. Shoots. Blocked. Here's Barron in front. Barron can't get a shot. Now the Blues are caught up ice. Gill to Gilmore. Over the red line. One man back. It's a 2-on-2. Gilmore stops in front. Gill. And he tips the puck wide. As Gill is taken down in the corner by Shanahan. Murray Barron with a puck for the Blues as the action is frantic. Here with 2:22 to go in game two of the Norris Division Finals. A Barron pass goes the length of the ice as Ellett touches the puck. It's an icing call against the Blues, and with 2:18 to go, this crowd in Toronto is going crazy.
Boy, what a save Curtis Joseph made on Dave Andrejczyk. The Blues turn the puck over in their own zone. Hedekin had a chance. He tries to poke check it. First of all, Zombo has it. Hedekin then has it, misses on the poke check, and then Gilmore setting up Andrejczyk. What a shot, what a save by Curtis Joseph to keep this game tied at one goal apiece. And of course, we've seen Doug Gilmore out on the ice. He just tries to set up one of his teammates, Todd Gill, going in for the net. Gill was able to get a stick on the puck and just deflected it wide.
From the faceoff, Gilmore centers for Toronto, and Rich Sutter gets the puck and clears it out. The Blues have Butcher and Brown on with a checking line of Basson, Miller, and Rich Sutter. Here's Rouse for Toronto in his own end. He's checked, loses the puck, knocked down. Then intercepting Miller, working in. Check, gets it to Basson, and McIlwain wrestles him out of the way of the net. And here's Ellett, a long feed for Clark by him. The puck the length of the ice. Jeff Brown back, and he touches the puck. And with a minute 45 to go in regulation play, an icing call against Toronto.
Ken, you were talking about how these fans here in Toronto have really taken on to this team. Well, certainly the majority of the credit, or a great deal of the credit, goes to Pat Burns, who has a good chance of winning the Coach of the Year honors in the National Hockey League. You know, you look at the way this team has gone as of late. Well, this is the first year in the last 14 that this Toronto Maple Leaf team has ended up with a better than 500 record in the regular season. And Pat Burns has done a wonderful job.
The last 7 shots on goal in this third period have belonged to Toronto. They're out shooting the Blues 44-26. Including 11-4 in this third period. Down to a minute 38 to go in regulation. Tied at one. McCowan for Toronto. Left wing to Andrejczyk. He slides the puck in. Gilmore slowed up by Zombo. And Hedekin for the Blues from behind his net. The rookie defenseman up to Lowry. Lowry gets to the red line. Shoots the puck in. It's Lowry, Wilson, and Hull for the Blues. Hull with the Blues' only goal. Lowry intercepts, can't center. Here's Lefebvre ahead to Gilmore, who has Toronto's goal. 2 Blues back in the playoff side. That pass from inside the Toronto line and out over the center red line, and the action stopped with 1:13 remaining here in the third period. Doug Gilmore's mom and dad on the left, Dad Don. They had other sons who could play the game. Don used to coach Doug and the other sons, and the other boys in not only hockey, but also in baseball. They're quite a family, the Gilmore family, and they have to be very proud of Doug, who, of course, was originally drafted by St. Louis, played with the Blues, then on to Calgary, a Stanley Cup, and he's trying to bring a Stanley Cup to Toronto.
Boy, and it makes you think of that big trade going back to last year where Cliff Fletcher acquired Doug Gilmore, Jamie McCowan, Rick Natras, Rick Wamsley, and Kent Manderville, sending or bringing those players and sending Gary Lehman, Michel Petit, Craig Berube, Alexander Gadynyuk, and Jeff Reese to the Calgary Flames. Boy, you talk about a one-sided trade. Calgary or Toronto certainly got the better of that deal.
Cliff Fletcher making up for the Brett Hull deal that he made with the Blues. Cliff Fletcher quoted all this week as saying, "I took a vote of everybody in the organization, and they all said, yes, trade Brett Hull to the Blues." Now Shanahan under a minute to go. Stops, goes again into the corner. Checked by Lefebvre behind the net. Centers hits the back of the net, and the puck cleared by Zezel over the glass and into the crowd, and we're down to 50.7 seconds to go in regulation play here in the second game of the Norris Division Finals. Bob Berry coached in L.A., Montreal, Pittsburgh early in Mario Lemieux's career, and this is the first time he has coached a team in the playoffs into the second round. And I'll tell you something, he's done a great job since taking over early in the season and turned this team around.
He really has, and he turned this team from a team that was porous defensively and everyone was going every which way. He molded this team, brought them together, taught them to play together as a team, and in February they finally came together, started believing in his system, and he has done an outstanding job.
And that, of course, is Bob Berry we're talking about, and much the same can be said about Pat Burns. As I remember, he told me in December at the arena in St. Louis, he said, "Our team is awful." And of course, they became much better. Here they come, 42 seconds to go. Osborne over the line, drops the puck for Zezel. A shot right on! The save by Joseph McCowan may have tipped it. Out at center ice, McCowan catches up with a puck, loses it to Shanahan. He can't get around Bill Berg. Then Berg bumped hard to the ice by Butcher. But a pass from Zezel. Long shot deflects off Brown wide. 20 seconds to go in the third. The Leafs are changing. The Blues can't get the puck out. Now a chance for Roush in front of Berg. A drive, the save, and Gilmore robbed with 10 seconds to go. The Leafs robbed by Joseph. Now here comes Miller for the Blues, shooting the puck in. He loses it. 1 second to go. Long shot by Ellett. It's stopped by Joseph. And as was the case in game one, game two of the Norris Division Finals will go into overtime, tied at one, and is Curtis Joseph unbelievable?
Well, Toronto really came on here in the last 25 seconds of this period. The Blues gave up a 3-on-2, then they couldn't clear the zone. Jamie McCowan had a chance. Doug Gilmore is going to try and finish things off for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Toronto with Bill Berg in front, he gets one shot, and Gilmore is right there, and as he tries to put in the rebound, Joseph comes up with the great save.
On a hot, muggy, rainy night in Toronto with a temperature unbelievably high with all sorts of humidity in Maple Leaf Gardens, these two teams wearily will head to overtime. Brett Hull has scored for the Blues, Doug Gilmore for Toronto, and that was way back in the first period. Stay with us. Overtime coming up here at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
A third period score sheet, huh? A third period score sheet, huh?
Yeah. Okay. How long do you think for the one ESPN first?
Supposed to be Mike B.
Welcome back to Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, Ontario, a familiar sight. The Blues and the Maple Leafs all tied at one goal apiece as we get ready for overtime. Joe Micheletti, Ken Wilson, and Bruce Affleck here at historic Maple Leaf Gardens, and these teams have battled here again tonight. Coach Pat Burns and his team have played hard, played well in their zone. Again, they've had trouble figuring out how to beat goaltender Curtis Joseph. Bob Barry's team has played more inspired the last couple of periods of this game, and they've had difficulty as well with youngster rookie Felix Pape.
Including the regular season, the Blues and Leafs in this building have played six games this season, and five of them have gone into overtime. Is that amazing? These two teams even played a tie in the regular season in St. Louis, an overtime game.
And we should see a lot of Doug Gilmore in this overtime. In game one, he played 7 minutes and 35 seconds in the third period, but then played 11 minutes in the first overtime.
Now from the faceoff, the puck slides to Joseph, who makes the save. He gives the puck to Zombo, who's on defense with Hedekin. A pass deflected by Wilson off Lefebvre the length of the ice. Lefebvre, who's on defense with Ellick for Toronto, has the puck behind his net. Gilmore skates by, doesn't take the puck. Gilmore on with Borshevsky and Andrychuk. The puck up to center ice off Andrychuk, the length of the ice. He was shy of the red line. Zombo touches the puck, and an icing call against the Toronto Maple Leafs just in the first minute of the first overtime period, tied at one.
I had a chance to talk to Bill Waters, who's the assistant general manager of the Toronto Maple Leafs. And this morning I jokingly said to him, what is your job now, to sign Doug Gilmore to a new contract? And he kind of laughed. He says, you know, it's interesting. When we made the trade with Calgary, Doug Gilmore wanted $750,000. Calgary wouldn't give that to him. When they made the trade, he got here. Cliff Fletcher gave him a four-year contract for $1 million a year. And now he's playing like a $3 million a year player.
Ken Wilson, Joe Micheletti, Bruce Affleck just underway the first overtime period. These two teams played double overtime in game one of the Norris Division Finals on Monday night. A Leafs pass goes the length of the ice. Back to touch the puck is Zombo. And again, it is an icing call against the Toronto Maple Leafs.
And Dave Lowry in game number one had some excellent chances, especially in overtime for Bob Barry's team, and was just unable to get anything past Felix Potvin.
Pat Burns, four seasons at Montreal. What a job he has done here in Toronto. And Bob Barry, longtime assistant with the Blues under Brian Sutter, was assistant GM starting the season, pressed into duty, and he has brought his team to the Norris Division Finals. The Blues, of course, did not know they'd make the Stanley Cup playoffs until the third period of their final game in the regular season. So ranking the teams 1 through 16 coming into the playoffs, the Blues were 16th. Now McCowan for Toronto. On with Rouse. Zezel centering a line with Berg and Osborne for Toronto. Left wing to Bill Berg. Now to Peter Zezel. Long shot and save by Joseph. Butcher gets the puck up to Shanahan. On with Emerson, who takes a pass, and Janney. Janney trails Emerson over the line. Emerson across for Shanahan, and the puck tipped away. Out at center ice, Zezel for Toronto, working into the Blues zone. He has the puck along the board, centers off Butcher and Brown. Now for the Blues. Shoots the puck off the boards. It hits Zezel, comes to the Blues, and here's Emerson. Now to Janney. Into the Toronto zone. Janney in front for Emerson. He gets a weak shot away and a relatively easy save for Potvin. And play stopped here early in overtime.
And Garth Butcher, following up on the play, gets into a pushing match in front of goaltender Felix Potvin and finishes off by putting his glove on the nose and squeezing a little bit, the nose of Bill Berg in front of the net.
Peter Zezel, he has been brilliant in each of these games of the Norris Division Finals.
Well, he's regarded as, you know, or known really for his excellent face-off ability, which he does very well, but here early in overtime took a long shot on Curtis Joseph that Joseph had to make the save on.
A 18:39, the time on the clock in the first overtime, the 20-minute period. Sudden death, they play until somebody wins. That somebody was Toronto early in the second overtime in game one on a Doug Gilmore goal. Zezel faces off against Basson to Potvin's left, up back to Hall to control the shot right on. Potvin the save, and Ella takes care of the rebound up to Anderson. Anderson now to Clark, back to Glenn Anderson, a backhand to the shot, the save, and the puck hits the top of the net just behind the crossbar. Hall clears it up on the left wing to Miller, who gets to the red line and shoots the puck in, and the Blues make a quick change for Toronto. Clears out to center ice by Cantal, a race. Clark gets by Cantal. He's hooked down. No penalty. Paul Stewart looks the other way. Then Hedekin clears up the boards and out to center ice. Gill loses the puck to Miller. Miller for St. Louis over the line. Can't get around Todd Gill. Gill off the near boards to Clark. Clark into the blue zone. Cuts to the middle. Keeps the puck in. Feeds too far for Ellett. Rich Sutter back behind his net. Has trouble with McElwain. Runs into his teammate Hedekin. Clears up around the boards. Gill loses the puck and the Blues clear it out. After it, Rich Sutter. He goes around Andrechuk into the corner. He's rammed down by McCown, and he gets up. The puck cleared up the boards to the point. Hedekin a shot wide of the Toronto net. Here's Jamie McCown for the Leafs. He's run hard. Then he collides with Lowry. And the Leafs, Andrechuk clears the puck out. And Zombo for St. Louis at his own line. A pass knocked away by Gilmore. Then Hedekin shoots the puck the length of the ice. McCown, who's lost his helmet, goes back to touch the puck. A whistle and an icing call against the Blues. As the overtime period is now 2 minutes and 54 seconds old, and Toronto has reached 50 shots on Curtis Joseph tonight.
And Joseph has been spectacular again tonight. And of course, he's used to this type of thing. Even in game number one, with all those great saves, he was still fresh at the end. His last good save on Glenn Anderson, who with the backhand tries to beat Joseph high. Joseph made the save. The puck ended up on the top of the net before falling off the other side.
Curtis Joseph has been better than good, to be sure, here in game two as he starred in game one. Blues win the faceoff. Butcher behind his net. Up for Hall. He can't take the pass. At center ice, Lefebvre for Toronto shoots the puck in. Brown has it caught in his paraphernalia, and referee Paul Stewart will stop play, and we've seen 3 minutes, 3 seconds of action here in overtime.
And what a marvelous year for Jeff Brown, and it's been very difficult in this series for Brown. We saw him very offensive against the Chicago Blackhawks, able to move up on the play. But this Toronto team is so defensive-minded. Meanwhile, just prior to all this, Rich Sutter going in and Jamie McCown coming all the way from the other side. What a hit on Richie Sutter in the Toronto zone.
Boy, this is great hockey. The NHL Stanley Cup playoffs. And we're happy to have you with us wherever you're watching tonight around the United States. Maple Leaf Gardens, Toronto, a shrine. They won a lot of Stanley Cups here in the 60s. They won one in 51 after a series of Stanley Cups in the 40s, but it's been a long drought since 67 and the Punch Imlach era. The Blues, of course, have never won a Stanley Cup, coming in the six-team expansion in 1967. From the faceoff, the puck back to Toronto goalie Felix Potvin, who, yes, is only 21 years of age. Sylvain Lefebvre behind his net for the Leafs. Up the far wing, the puck tipped down the ice. Darting back is Brown. He'll touch the puck, and it's an icing call against Toronto. If you might think that they're playing rather conservatively here, let's go back 48 hours, Joe, to game one on Monday night. There were endless great scoring opportunities in that first 20-minute overtime period.
Yeah, both teams loosened up quite a bit, and both goaltenders were forced to come up with great saves. You know, here's another interesting point about Curtis Joseph. When he got hurt in game one and had to leave for 2 minutes and 16 seconds because of that skate laceration along his right cheek, Guy Hebert had to come in. He made one save, but it was an outstanding save against Nikolai Borshevsky. And on the whistle, when Joseph came back onto the ice, he apologized to Guy Hebert, said, "I'm sorry I had to put you through this." And Guy just turned back to him and said, "Listen, if you want me to stay, I'm okay, I'll stay." And he said, "No, I'll handle it." So
they, of course, are best of friends, Curtis Joseph and backup goalie Guy Hebert. Boy, there are a couple of good ones. And Guy Hebert is an outstanding goalie, but Joseph has been so great the last two or three months that Hebert hasn't had much opportunity. The faceoff to Felix Potvin's left. Brendan Shanahan will step up against Peter Zezel.
And now every faceoff in Toronto's zone on that side, Bob Barry puts Brett Hull back in the slot, hoping that the Blues can win one faceoff and get it back to Hull.
There's the Blues captain right behind Shanahan. Each team has had a couple of shots on goal in the overtime. Leafs win the draw. Hull is replaced by Emerson. Lefebvre up the wing. Berg slowed up. And Shanahan rifles the puck right back in. Emerson, Jannan, Shanahan, Brown, and Butcher for the Blues. This is Lefebvre for Toronto. A pass up for Berg by him and off Butcher the length of the ice. And this is Jeff Brown, the Blues all-star defenseman who had to miss the all-star game back earlier in the year when he broke his foot shortly before the big game. Now Butcher, a pass for Emerson, racing up the left wing into the Toronto end. He stops, the pass across for Butcher, and he fans. Here's Mark Osborne at center ice for Zezel. 2-on-2. Rouse over the line with him. A drive, great save! Zezel robbed by Joseph. Left point, Ellett steps into a shot, and it deflects wide off Butcher. Emerson hits Butcher with a clearing effort. The Leafs are changing. The Blues want to change. End of a shift. Now the puck hit by a high stick. Osborne knocks it down. And as Gill touches it, Paul Stewart stops play. And we're down to 15:38 to go in overtime period one.
Well, again, Curtis Joseph with another tremendous save. 51 shots now for the Toronto Maple Leafs. You know, we talked about Zezel and his outstanding ability to win faceoffs, but he also has a great shot. He just doesn't shoot that often. He found himself at the top of the circle, and he decided to take the shot. But the excellent concentration and positioning of Curtis Joseph, and he comes up with the save.
From a neutral faceoff, Ellett shoots the puck in along the boards, a battle for it. Miller gets the puck behind the Blues net to Kintal. Kintal clears up right wing for Rich Sutter, on with Bassan and Miller. The puck ahead, Bassan overskates it, now shoots it wide of the Toronto net. Along the near side, Pearson chops the puck, not out. Barron keeps it in, but then the Leafs take over. Gill over to Ellett, who charges over the red line. Fakes a shot, works in, but Clark is offside on the near right wing, and that Ellett fake caused a problem for Wendell Clark.
Well, I think if you talk to any of the Toronto people around here and ask them who has been the top defenseman on this team all season, they'll talk about Dave Ellett. He has really been a steadying force for this team. Spent many years in Winnipeg, had some good offensive numbers, but coming here to Toronto, he has not only continued to play well offensively, but under the defensive system of coach Pat Burns, he has really turned into a leader.
The Blues eliminated Chicago in four straight. Pat Burns' Leafs needed seven to eliminate Detroit. The winner of this best of seven Norris Division final series will take on the winner of the Los Angeles Kings Vancouver Canucks series, the Smythe Division finals. And their game tonight at the Pacific Coliseum is 1-1. Of course, Vancouver won the opening game. Now the faceoff outside the St. Louis blue line. Lowry facing off with Gilmore. Lowry wins the draw. Zombo with a puck over to Hedekin. Hedekin out of his own end. Now to the red line. A pass out of Lowry's reach. And the puck to Ellett. He slams it off the stick of Gilmore. And here is Gil moving in. A shot. Oh, and Hedekin back. Diving. And the puck deflects off Hedekin's stick and into the crowd. And the speed of the rookie Blues defenseman, Brett Hedekin, paid off there.
That's an outstanding defensive play because Ron Wilson was the other player back for the Blues, and there was some miscommunication. They both went to the same player. Hedekin noticed it, released, went all the way to the other side, and with that speed, he just dove and deflected the shot by Todd Gill up and over the glass. Boy, that's a big league play because both Wilson and Hedekin had gone way to one side, and Hedekin Hagen came back with the play.
Here's Andrechuk from the faceoff, a save. Gilmore centers Barshevsky alone, and the shot deflects wide. Joseph has lost his stick. He's trying to get it. A shot goes wide. He finally picks up the stick, and Lowry clears the puck out. The game's two goal scorers are on the ice. You just saw Doug Gilmore. Brad Hull is on the ice for the Blues. It's 1-1 in overtime period one. Ellett for the Leafs in his own end, a pass to center ice. Barshevsky deflects the puck to Joseph. Hedekin for the Blues. The Leafs completing a line change. Hedekin ahead to Lowry. Now to Hall. Here's Hall with Lowry and Wilson. Hall a blast off Todd Gill's stick, over the glass and into the end seats here at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Well, Bob Barry has used a lot of different line matchups tonight, and he's coached differently in this game than he did in game one regarding the line matchups. Meanwhile, a great chance for Toronto to win this right off the faceoff. Gilmore's going to end up with the puck. Now, Barshevsky is 16 right in front. Ron Wilson dives to block the shot. It was a delayed pass. Wilson slid right by. That left Barshevsky all alone with Curtis Joseph. And Joseph is able to scramble down. Barshevsky trying to handle the puck, but the puck is rolling on in. Barshevsky couldn't get a good handle on the puck. This ice has been soft. It's been hot in here tonight. And Barshevsky's shot up and over the glass. What a chance.
The only difference in this game from game one Monday night, as Brown sends one on goal and Potvin makes the save, is that Toronto completely dominated the first period. They didn't have that situation in game one. Yet tonight, after a period, it was 1-1, and we're still 1-1 in the first overtime. Just past the six-minute mark of overtime, here's Jeff Brown up the ice trying to split the defense, and he's spun around by McCowan at the last minute, and McCowan backhands the puck into the crowd. 13:42 to go in overtime. Hall and Gilmore scoring the game's only goals in the first period.
And that last rush by Jeff Brown was very typical of the way Toronto's defense plays. Once you get inside the line, 15, 20, 25 feet out, they just converge on you. Bob Rouse, number three, 34 is Jamie McCowan. They just take that center of the ice away and really prevent you from getting any good scoring chances from the 20 to 25 foot mark.
Toronto had 64 shots on goal in the double overtime game Monday night. They already have 52 here in this one. The Blues have 29 shots on Potvin. McCowan, number 34 for Toronto, on defense with Rouse. Looks up the ice. Feeds to Rouse. Berg up front with Zezel and Osborne. This team's line, this line right here, has been very dangerous in overtime. And this time the Leafs are offside at the St. Louis blue line. And that'll bring a line change for Bob Barry and the Blues.
Well, Bob Rouse said after game one, he said, boy, it was nice to play a team where they only forechecked with one player. He says the Detroit series, Detroit always forechecked with two players and made it very difficult to go back, get the puck, and make plays coming out of your own zone. But in game one, the Blues did not have their forechecking going, and Pat Burns' defense had really an easy time of getting the puck and moving it out of their own zone. It's been a little bit different here tonight.
It is overtime, though. 1-1. Ken Wilson and Joe Micheletti, the Blues and the Leafs. Barron to center ice, shoots a puck in. It deflects just beyond Rich Sutter, but again, the Blues are offside, and this first overtime period has been filled with many whistles.
Yeah, it really has. Most of them offsides, Ken. Both teams trying to just get the edge, get the jump. They're trying to dump it in, and they're trying to be the first player on the puck to cause a turnover and to prevent, or actually to start, a scoring chance.
Dave Ellett, veteran defenseman, his dad played years ago in the American Hockey League. He's on with Gill. Anderson takes the puck, slides it back to his goaltender. Anderson and Clark are the wings. Dave McElwain did not play in game one. He's at center for Toronto. Good defensive player. Leafs break out. Anderson, a pass for Clark, tipped away by Kintal. Then Kintal rubs out Clark just enough to allow the puck to be shot in, and the Leafs clear to center ice. Here's Barron, a pass to Rich Sutter. He winds up, long shot wide of the Toronto net. McElwain fails to get the puck. A battle, and the Leafs come up with it. Up to Glenn Anderson. Right wing feed to Clark. Clark for Gill. And the puck tipped away by Bassin, and Miller takes it from Barron. Here's Kevin Miller. He can show you some moves. Right side to Cantal, and he shoots the puck in for St. Louis. The Blues are changing. Hoffman knocked down as he and his teammate Gil collide. The puck in front. Wilson misses it. Zombo a shot blocked by Clark. Zombo a pass. Deflection by Wilson right on. And Hoffman a save. And a player down and hurt. It is Wendell Clark. And that's why referee Paul Stewart stops play. Clark gets up. And he is favoring a leg. But what a save by Hoffman. Wilson.
And Clark may have saved the game for Toronto, as there was a turnover, a misplay behind the net by Potvin. There was an open net momentarily. The puck will end up back to the point. Now 17 is Clark. He just goes straight down and blocks the long shot by Zombo, who regains the puck and sees Wilson to the side. Potvin anticipates that play perfectly and comes up with a great save on the deflection of the Ron Wilson tip-in. Potvin from behind the net, a crazy bounce off the boards. He couldn't play it. And momentarily, Hull had an open net before the puck eventually comes back to the point where Clark really makes a gutsy play going down to block the shot of Rick Zombo.
12:22 to go in overtime period one. The Blues and the Leafs are tied at one. Coming into the series, the Blues had a huge statistical advantage on the special teams. But in the first game, Toronto did get a power play goal and won it in double overtime 2-1. Tonight, Toronto getting their goal again on the power play, but very few penalties. The Leafs 1-for-3 in the power play tonight. The Blues, who have really had a potent power play most of the season and in the playoffs, 0-for-1 in the power play tonight. That was a very costly play there, almost, for Toronto.
Yeah, it really was, with Potvin behind the net. And again, a puck took a strange bounce, and we've talked about it through the course of the game tonight. It's extremely warm in here. The humidity is high. The ice is not in very good shape. So we've seen a lot of pucks bouncing over sticks and taking crazy deflections off the boards.
Now the Kings lead 3-1 in Vancouver. It's 1-1 here in Toronto in overtime. Game two of the Norris Division Finals. The Leafs clear the puck all the way to Joseph. Here's Zombo. A pass for Wilson off the boards. Too far for Hull. McCowan now gets the puck ahead. Played by Andrechuk to Gilmore. He's checked by Hedekin, but flips the puck into the corner, and Lowry back for St. Louis. And he flips the puck over the glass into the crowd, and the faceoff will be in the circle near Blues goaltender Curtis Joseph.
Well, we talked about Doug Gilmore, and by the way, Wendell Clark went to the Toronto dressing room after blocking that shot and is now back on the Toronto bench. And we talked about Gilmore and his 41 minutes of ice time in game number one. Well, immediately following the game, he went right to the dressing room and received a 15-minute rubdown on his legs. He came out, met the press, and then went back in for another 20-minute rubdown on the rest of his body. And they say that's to get the lactic acid out of the legs. It's worked for him.
I know, Dr. Micheletti, you may not explain that any further, though. But a good job to the point you took it.
That's as much as I've got.
Now the Blues, Barron with a puck. Up to Miller. He's slowed up by Cullen, who's appearing in overtime for the first time. Cullen didn't play much in the third period. And finally, here is Lefebvre in the center circle. He'll shoot the puck into the St. Louis zone. Joseph fails to stop it behind the net. Here is Rob Pearson. He gets bumped by Basson. The puck battled for, and Basson clears it out. Lefebvre over to Ellett. Ellett works in, dumps the puck behind the Blues net, and back for his Barron. Now the Leafs appear to be outworking the Blues a little bit here. Then Rich Sutter bumps Cullen from behind. A fight for the puck in front of the Toronto bench. And Miller gets it as the crowd chants, "Go Leafs, go! Go Leafs, go!" And a pass from Miller to Janney, too far. Here come the Leafs. Three Blues are back. It's a 4-on-3. Pearson over the line. Drops the puck to Manderville. His shot, and it's blocked by Butcher. After the puck, Janney. He gets there. A feed too far for Shanahan, and here is Lefebvre back as Toronto is changing on the fly. 9:15 gone in the first overtime period. 1-1. Janney intercepts, works in on the right wing. Looks for Shanahan and Butcher. The pass to Butcher to Shanahan, and a shot wide. Near side, here's Brown. Brown over to Emerson. He'll shoot just wide, and the puck behind the Toronto net picked up by McCowan. And he's got a burst of speed up to the red line. Defenseman Jamie McCowan into the blue zone. Stops, passes in front. Butcher breaks up the play as the pass was intended for Bird. Now both teams changing. Rouse for Toronto drills the punt back in. Zezel has teammate Osborne get to the punt. They can't make a play. Now Zezel ridden out by Brown behind the net. Zezel is dazed. Here's Emerson with a puck. Zezel still on the ice, and he finally gets up. Emerson on the attack for the Blues. Over the line. 4-on-3 is shot. And Potvin the save. McCowan for Toronto fires the puck the length of the ice. Now a race. Osborne will get to the puck before Zombo. He works in. He shoots. The save by Joseph. Oh, baby, what a save by Curtis Joseph on Mark Osborne. And play is stopped here in overtime.
And Rick Zombo ended up making an outstanding defensive play. As the puck came down the ice, Gilmore was hooking Zombo to slow him down to allow Osborne to get to the puck in the far right corner. But then Zombo made a very smart play. Instead of going after Osborne, he stopped and stayed right in front of the net and in front of Curtis Joseph. Osborne had to walk in, and from a bad angle, ends up taking the shot that Joseph was able to make the save on and then cover up for the rebound with Gilmore right there.
Boy, it's getting more exciting here in this overtime period. How long will it go?
Well, Osborne again with the puck. He's able to walk in. Now Zombo just holds his ground right in front of the net. Gilmore is just on the other side, and Joseph makes the save.
St. Louis controls the faceoff. Hedekin a pass that hits Miller in the skate. They tie the puck up along the boards, and play is stopped. Boy, these teams still seem to have energy. We can't emphasize how humid, how hot it is here in Maple Leaf Gardens tonight. Of course, it's an old, old structure, and it's a long way from a building that can be cooled down readily.
Now, I asked Pat Burns about the temperature in game one, and he said, even down on the bench, he says he has never been in this building where it's been that hot. He says it's just unbelievable down there near the ice.
And during the second intermission, Blues centerman Bob Basson telling us all that it's hotter tonight than it was on Monday night. Here's Hedekin. He can't work in, and Lefebvre clears the center ice. Basson knocks the puck away, and Rich Sutter takes over. This is the Blues checking line. Rich Sutter on the right wing. Hedekin goes to the net, and the pass shot misses the mark. Here comes Toronto back. 3-on-3. Anderson over the line. Stop. Quintal in the corner. Ridden to the boards by Anderson. Then McIlwain trying to get the puck, and he can't. And Basson gets it, and it deflects to center ice. Rich Sutter takes Gill down. Wendell Clark has the puck. Clark on the left wing working in. He's stopped, taken down by Basson. And Rich Sutter sends the puck high, and it'll bounce down at the Toronto blue line.
Yesterday.
Rouse looks up the ice, feeds to Rouse. Berg up front with Zezel and Osborne. This team's line, this line right here, has been very dangerous in overtime, and this time the Leafs are offside at the St. Louis blue line, and that'll bring a line change for Bob Berry and the Blues.
Well, Bob Rouse said after game one, he said, boy, it was nice to play a team where they only forechecked with one player. He says the Detroit series, Detroit always forechecked with two players and made it very different on the Blues. Bobby Rouse, skating along the right-hand boards, lets a shot go from just inside the top of the circle, and Curtis Joseph came up with a good glove save.
8-11 remaining in overtime, period one. The Blues and the Leafs are tied at one. Hall and Gilmore getting the goals in the first period. Gilmore's power play goal was very controversial. They had to use the instant replay upstairs to determine that the puck had barely trickled over the goal line. Now the faceoff to Potvin's right. Zezel against Wilson. Wilson on with Lowry and Hall, Butcher and Brown. Osborne and Berg are the forwards on the line with Zezel. Elliott and Lefebvre on defense for Toronto. Zezel wins the faceoff. Toronto very good on faceoffs. Now to Lefebvre. Lefebvre right wing for Osborne, and he'll dump the puck in. He's checked. That gives Butcher time behind the St. Louis net. And Butcher in trouble. He gives the puck to Brown, who's lost his helmet. Up to the veteran Wilson, the oldest player on either team. And Berg intercepts. He's lost his helmet and backhands the puck in. And here's Brown. Now Toronto trying to change. Left wing to Lowry out of his own end. Rink wide pass for Wilson flying in. He's taken out in the corner by Elliott. Then Andrechuk there. He's ridden into by Lowry, and three players go down. And Lowry trying to get the puck out of the corner. He's wrestled down by Andrechuk. Here's Ron Wilson now for the Blues. Oh, Andrechuk won't let Lowry up. He's got him in a headlock. Now Wilson for the Blues. And the puck stolen and play stopped. Referee Paul Stewart stopping play as Andrechuk practically undresses Lowry in that corner. So great action here in overtime at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. Boy, oh boy, can you believe that this game would go into overtime 1-1, as did the opening game of this best of seven series on Monday night. And that game was, well, one of the finest playoff games you'd ever see. And this one has had plenty of action in its own right.
Well, we've seen a little bit of everything here tonight. We've seen some great scoring chances. Certainly the goaltending, especially Curtis Joseph, has been terrific again. And Felix Potvin, very good as well. Well, Dave Lowry was coming into the play now. Andrechuk is number 14. He comes back. Now Lowry from behind runs into Andrechuk. Now Paul Stewart, the referee, is watching. Andrechuk tries to spear him, and then we turn into World Wrestling Federation stuff as Andrechuk and Lowry just continue to go at it. Paul Stewart lets it go. A couple of takedowns by both players. Lowry ends up on top before the whistle is finally blown. And Andrechuk and Lowry will both go off, so we'll play some four-on-four hockey here.
The Blues tend to get a little conservative at times, four-on-four. Toronto earlier in this game in a four-on-four situation went with Doug Gilmore and Nikolai Borshevsky, and that, of course, creates some concerns for Bob Berry and the Blues.
And Pat Burns is responding the same type of way. He's got Dave McIlwain out on the ice right now, who is a defensive-minded center and hasn't played much in the playoffs, and Glenn Anderson. So he's got a defensive player and an offensive player, and the Blues and Bob Berry have countered with Bob Bassin and Kevin Miller.
Andrechuk and Lowry, coincidental two-minute roughing minors here at 12:44 of overtime. This is the first time we have seen penalties in this game called by Paul Stewart since just about 5 minutes to go way back in the second period, and there haven't been many penalties at all tonight. That seems to be a pattern we've seen a lot of in the Stanley Cup playoffs this spring. Here's Anderson working in for Toronto against Brown, taken down. Anderson has the puck under his body, and play is stopped, and that means the faceoff will come outside the St. Louis blue line.
Well, there was so much speculation that Glenn Anderson may not have played in this game tonight. Most everyone was waiting for the NHL to make a ruling on the spearing incident in game one. Meanwhile, Anderson, with great speed, tries to beat Jeff Brown to the outside. Brown is able to, first of all, deflect the puck with his stick on a poke check, and then Anderson ends up on the puck, so the faceoff comes outside the Blues' blue line.
The 17th overtime game of the 93 Stanley Cup playoffs is tied at one, the Blues and the Maple Leafs. The faceoff outside the St. Louis blue line, the team's four skaters aside, under 7 minutes remaining in overtime period one. Rouse has the puck at his own blue line for Toronto. He is on with McCowan, and Borchevsky, who gets the puck, is up front with Gilmore. Both quick, both shifty, and both can put it in. Borchevsky right wing to Gilmore. He stops. Doug Gilmore feeds across to McCown. He flips the puck to the net. Joseph makes the save. Clears the puck up to Emerson. He's poke-checked, and Butcher has to cover up. He flips the puck to the near corner to Shanahan, and the Blues looking for a little room. Now to Butcher. Butcher up to Emerson on the move, up the right wing, over the red line, and he can't move in. The puck really bouncing with a lot of ruts right in front of the visitors' players' bench, and the Blues control the puck. Brown at his own end. 50 seconds to go in the coincidental minor penalties. Over to Butcher, now to Wilson. The puck deflects near the Toronto goal, and McCowan controls for the Maple Leafs. Up the near wing to Borchevsky. He is checked by Hedekin. Loose puck, here's Wilson. Leaving it for Hull. Hull's in trouble, but he makes a nice move. Hull, now to Wilson. Blues are changing a shot. Oh, and it goes over the net. Now McCowan trying to clear. Zombo stops that pass. Zombo is checked by McCowan, and the puck behind the Toronto net. Rouse holds on to Wilson. Leafs trying to clear. Can't. Contal, a shot. And that deflects over the net, the glass, and into the crowd. And we're down to 5:28 remaining here in the first overtime, and there are 12 seconds to go in the shorthanded situations for both teams.
And rookie defenseman Brent Hedekin stepping up to take Nikolai Borchevsky, gives him one push, and then Borchevsky and Hedekin with their sticks up. Hedekin gets the worst of it as he catches Borchevsky's stick, and he made his way to the Blues bench area where Dr. Gilden and trainer Tom Nash are attending to Brent Hedekin.
Toronto now has had 55 shots on goal. The Blues have had 33. Again, in game one, Toronto outshot the Blues with 64 Toronto shots on Monday night. The Blues had 34. Boy, I don't know. How does Curtis Joseph do it? Here the Blues, Kintal can't control. Now Zezel flips the puck ahead, and Barron has it. Barron in his own end, fans finally ahead now to Shanahan, and Zezel steals the puck. Now the penalties are over. Lowry and Andrechuk back on. Leafs shoot the puck in. Andrechuk slowed up by Lowry. Kintal leaves it for Shanahan. He has Osborne on his back, smashes it around far side, and Janney is onside. Gill is back with Ellett. Janney a drive, and Papin a save on Craig Janney. Then Ellett clears the center ice. Here's Zezel for Toronto. Zezel poke check, leaves it for Osborne in front. Berg a shot. Oh, and another brilliant save by Curtis Joseph. Then Zezel and Brown slash at each other in the corner. Oh, baby, what a save by Curtis Joseph. Oh, that's unbelievable. What action. It has opened up quite a bit here as this first overtime period has continued on, and we're down to 4:46 now to go in overtime, tied at one, and Toronto has really had many greater scoring chances tonight, as you might expect, than the Blues. But again, like Monday night, either team has been in a position to put an end to this game.
Well, Zezel had control of the puck. He'll end up dropping the puck to Mark Osborne. Now both Blues players go back to the net. Osborne with the perfect pass over to Bill Berg, who got away from Emerson, and Joseph with another save.
Now long pass to Rich Sutter. He loses the puck. Leafs trying to clear. Here's Rouse working out. Rouse to the red line. Rouse into the Blues zone. Spun around by Butcher, who's grabbing and shoving at anything in white. Leafs clear around far side. Clark gets the puck, shoots it to Anderson behind the net. He's checked. Now it's loose far side. Here's Wendell Clark. A shot to save. Loose puck as it gets behind Joseph, and Brown clears it away. Miller at center ice to Rich Sutter. He's knocked down. Butcher tries to shoot the puck in, and play is getting considerably more chippy here late in the first overtime. Zombo for the Blues. Feeds to the near wing to Lowry. Oh, he's stepped into by McCowan. Now both teams are changing. Under 4 minutes to go in the first 20-minute overtime period. McCowan ahead for Borshevsky. And it's offside. The Leafs are offside on the play. And we're down to 3:45 to go in a jam-packed Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Boy, and what an opportunity here. Clark just from the board throws it in front. Now Joseph makes a save, but it hits the skate of Bob Bassin and comes right back into the crease. And a very alert play by Jeff Brown, who sees it. He looks and just dives before Dave McElwain can get to the loose puck. Joseph was out of the play, and McElwain had an opportunity. Boy, what a game Jamie McCowan has played, both offensively and physically, as he takes Dave Lowry heavily into the boards.
And we are obviously early in this best of seven series, and already two overtime games here in Toronto. Game three will be Friday night in St. Louis. What a series this is developing into. Leafs shoot the puck in. Zombo behind the net with Hedekin. He gives Hedekin the puck. He flies up the left wing. Tips the puck in. He's taken out by Gill, and Gilmore for Toronto back behind his net. Now Gilmore starts out right wing to Gill over the red line. Gill into the blue zone, right wing to Andrechuk, and a shot goes wide. Trying to keep it in, and doing so is Gilmore. Then he hits the Blues player Shanahan up to Wilson over the line to Hall. Hall to Shanahan. Shanahan in the left wing in front for Hall. Hall a pass for Wilson. Hits a skate. Back the other way. Borchevsky leads the attack for Toronto. To Gilmore. Under 3 minutes to go in the first overtime. To Borchevsky. Weak shot. Knocked away. And then Gilmore taken into the net by Zombo. And it comes loose behind Curtis Joseph. And play is stopped with 2:47 to go here in the first overtime in Toronto. The Blues and Leafs tied at one.
Rick Zombo complaining that Doug Gilmore purposely knocked the net off its moorings. But it looks certainly accidental from the replay we see. Zombo and Gilmore. Zombo doing a good job taking Gilmore out of the play as Borshevsky was trying to put himself in a position to get a shot on goaltender Curtis Joseph.
Each team has had 8 shots on goal in this overtime. 2:47 to go in the first overtime. The Blues now have Barron and Quintal on defense. Janney, Shanahan, and Emerson up front. Pat Burns has Zezelon with Osborne and Pearson, McCowan, and Rouse.
Yeah, Pat Burns has only 2 players taking faceoffs in this game, Doug Gilmore and Peter Zezel.
And they dominated in that department in the first game. They've been strong tonight. Zezel loses this one, but goes after the puck. Zezel works behind the Blues net, tries to come in front. Good work defensively by Emerson. And Zezel overskates the puck. Janney works out 3-on-2, but he falls down. May have tripped over Shanahan. And the Leafs come back. Pearson stopped at the blue line by Emerson. Pearson trying to shoot the puck in once, can't. Now stick handles in. Far left wing to Zezel in front for Pearson. And he deflects the puck just wide as Barron had him. Now the puck sent it into the crease. It's loose. The play is stopped. Play stopped. Zezel is headlocked by Shanahan, but play is stopped. Paul Stewart, the referee, with a very prompt whistle. That's not a quick whistle, but a very prompt whistle. And the Leafs come very close again.
Well, Paul Stewart stayed very alert on the play. Murray Barron was tied up with Rob Pearson right along the side of the net. Now the puck was loose behind the net, and Toronto ended up getting control and just flipping the puck in front. And that type of play can end up in the net.
Now Paul Stewart. Paul Stewart was right behind the net. The goal judge slapped on the glass and told Stewart he wanted to talk to him. The goal judge got on the phone. Stewart coming over says, no way, no goal. But the goal judge wants to talk to Paul Stewart. Again, the off-ice officials in this series are from Ottawa.
Well, the puck took a funny bounce when it came from the side of the net and behind the net. Curtis Joseph was on the post, but there was a lot of traffic right next to him on the post, including Murray Barron and Rob Pearson. Now they're right along the side of the net, fighting it out, and from behind the net, Osborne took the shot that deflected off a skate and then hit Joseph. And we couldn't tell from that angle where the puck was, but the person with the best position on this play was the referee, Paul Stewart.
Now the faceoff in the blue zone, a battle in the corner for the puck. Cullen gets it. He's tied up by Basson. Boy, it's a real struggle now, folks. And play stopped as Berg and Butcher, who had many a confrontation during the regular 84-game season, wrestle on the ice, and Paul Stewart is going to wave both of them off, and that probably hurts the Blues more than it does the Maple Leafs.
Well, Berg, even when he was acquired from the New York Islanders, there was only two teams that he scored two goals against in a game. One of those was the Blues. He had a great year against the Blues, not only scoring a couple of game winners, but at the same time, he was shadowing Brett Hull during the regular season and helped tremendously in keeping the Blues off the scoreboard.
2 minutes, 6 seconds to go in the first overtime period. Brett Hull scored in the first period for the Blues. A power play goal in the first period by Doug Gilmore tied it. Berg gets two for holding, Butcher two for roughing here at 17:54. Toronto's shot total now, their shots on goal 56 and the Blues 34. The faceoff to Curtis Joseph's right, Basson against McIlwain, 4-on-4. Here is Zombo with a puck. Zombo on with Barron, Basson and Miller. Blues just flipped the puck out. Here's Lefebvre at his own line, over to Ellett, up to McIlwain off his skate. Anderson, the other Leaf player, he picks up a loose puck, fakes his shot, trying to cut in, goes behind the net, centers, and Basson intercepts, and it's 2-on-2, back the other way, Basson with Miller. Basson over the line, out of Miller. Pretty good scorer, shot, save, Basson, oh, he couldn't get a shot. He was tied up by Lefebvre. McIlwain the other way for Toronto, shoots the puck in. Joseph leaves it into the corner. Barron tied up by Anderson. Miller trying to pry the puck loose, and he does. A lot of open ice. Both teams are shorthanded. 1:20 to go in the first overtime. Tied at one. Miller to center ice, shoots the puck in. Both teams sending on some fresh players. Gilmore for Toronto. Up to Rouse. Rouse at center ice along the boards. Forced back in his own end by Hedekin. Now quick pass. Andrechuk with Gilmore. Brown and Wilson back, and Andrechuk shoots wide. McCowan keeps the puck in. Then Brown gets it. Ahead to Hedekin. Under a minute to go in the first overtime. Hedekin drop pass to Hall. Hall works in front of shot. Glove save by Potvin. Felix Potvin makes the save on Brett Hall.
Well, that was a 4-on-2 for the Blues. They had both defensemen, both Hedekin and Brown, moving up on the play. Hedekin with the drop pass to Hall, who's able to control it, and he let go that hard wrist shot of his, and Felix Potvin with that outstanding gloves hand comes up with the save. Meanwhile, Kevin Miller just prior to that let go a shot. Ellett was there. Potvin made the save. Bob Basson was trying to get the rebound. An outstanding defensive play by Sylvain Lefebvre, just lifting the stick of Basson before he could bat in the rebound.
The Blues now out shooting the Leafs 10-8 here in overtime, down to 48.4 seconds to go in the first overtime. Remember, game one just 48 hours ago was settled at 3:16 of the second overtime when Doug Gilmore scored after John Cullen had scored for Toronto in the first period and Philippe Bozon in the second for St. Louis. There hasn't been any scoring since the first period in this game. The Leafs, after a period, easily could have been up by 4 or 5 goals. That's how much they dominated the first period of this second game of the Norris Division Finals. But here we are, same old story, 1-1 in overtime. Now 38 seconds to go in overtime, the first overtime period. Zezel to McCowan. McCowan taken down by Shanahan. Lefebvre gets the puck ahead. Turned by Osborne to Zezel. Zezel over the line. Three Blues are back. Zezel in the corner falls down. Has the puck come loose. But referee Paul Stewart says that's enough. And he blows his whistle to stop play. And we're down to 21 and a half seconds to go in the fourth period of the game, the first overtime period.
And again, a very important faceoff coming up in the Blue zone. We've talked about Peter Zezel and Doug Gilmore and the great job that they have done in these two games, winning the majority of the faceoffs. Now with 21.5 seconds to go, Pat Burns puts Doug Gilmore back on the ice to take this faceoff.
Doug Gilmore, the same Doug Gilmore who lost 7 pounds in the heat here Monday night. And it is more humid, hotter here tonight. A lot of the fans, and you've probably seen them, sitting there fanning themselves. That is how stifling it is here at Maple Leaf Gardens tonight. Face off in the Blues zone, Zombo with a puck behind the net. 16 seconds to go in the first overtime. Now a pass out of Lowry's reach, the puck the length of the ice. Back touches it, and an icing against the Blues, and this will mean a very key faceoff and a possible chance for Toronto with 9.5 seconds to go in the overtime period.
Well, Bob Bastian did a great job on the faceoff against Doug Gilmore, winning the faceoff. And now coach Pat Burns makes a change and puts Peter Zezel back on the ice to try and win this faceoff. But Bastian had won the faceoff back to Rick Zombo, who carried the puck up the ice and tried to hit Dave Lowry on the breakaway, missed the pass. That led to the icing.
I do not know where the Toronto Maple Leafs are getting the energy. I believe it's their fourth overtime game in their last five. Obviously, they played 3 in a row. They won game 7 in Detroit in overtime. The first 2 games of this Norris Division final playoff series have gone to overtime. And, of course, it's not inexpensive overtime either here at Maple Leaf Gardens Monday night and tonight. We're talking about a lot of it. Gill from the point of shot, the save, the puck centered by Zezel. It's loose. Now here is Berg out of the penalty box, a shot that goes wide. Then Butcher takes Berg to the boards as the first overtime period comes to an end, with Leafs coach Pat Burns screaming, standing on the bench, wondering why they don't penalize Butcher.
Well, what happened on the play? Peter Zezel won the faceoff back to the point. Joseph made the save, and then it deflected, and then he hustled over to the other side of the net where Peter Zezel was trying to get the shot off. He was able to feed it back to Berg for the long shot that went wide.
The Blues in the overtime period outshoot Toronto 10-8. The shots on the night, 56 for the Leafs, 36 for the Blues. 1-1 after 4 periods at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Yeah. Okay, and Gary Sabourin is here too. He'll do the second part. Just let me know if I have to finish it too. Do you want me to finish it too? Understandable.
What are we doing here? Oh.
So I guess you're gonna...
It's
It's been a long time, but we did have two goals, both of them coming in the first period. Hull for the Blues, Gilmore for the Maple Leafs, and we are tied at one after one period of overtime. Welcome back to Maple Leaf Gardens. And our guest this time, Gary Sabourin, former winger for the St. Louis Blues. And we were talking before we went on the air, you recalling some of the overtime games in that first year. Bring us back in history a little bit.
Well, first of all, Bruce, thanks a lot for getting me over to do a little interview with you. And I'd like to say hello to a lot of the fans back in St. Louis that maybe remember the days of Sabourin and St. Marseille and Hall and Plante and Berenson and Plagers. And
they still talk about you.
Well, thank you. I it's a long time ago. I thought they'd have forgotten by now, but
I didn't say they talked good about you.
You never change either, do you? But no, it does remind me of some of the days of our early years, where I think we had three overtimes in the one Stanley Cup Finals, and of course Montreal beating us in all three games. But fantastic games, just like we're seeing tonight. And if these two goaltenders keep playing like this, we'll be here all night. So it could be a long night yet, but it's terrific to see, and the hockey's been fantastic.
Really
for both teams, and I know I've watched a lot of it on CBC up in Canada where I live now, and gosh, we've really enjoyed it. And we were real shocked to see St. Louis get by Chicago. I didn't think they would, and here they are. And I think they'll win this one tonight. I can't say that too loud since I'm in Toronto, but I think they will win tonight. And it's up for grabs, this series, as far as I'm concerned.
No question about it. I asked Kurt Giles how he enjoys watching the game. Obviously, he's still playing, so it's tough. You've been out of the league now for a while. How do you enjoy watching the games?
Well, I love watching them on TV. I don't go to many live games, but when you do go, I really enjoy it, because I tend to think back and I think, God, did we play this? Were we this fast? Were we this strong and all this hitting?
No, you weren't.
I guess we weren't. I can't believe that we could have been, but I guess we were in our own way. But the guys are so much bigger now, and I think stronger. But it was still great hockey back then. But we're seeing some tremendous hockey here by some talented players.
You gonna pick who's gonna get the game winner?
No, I'm not gonna do that. But my heart is with St. Louis. But I don't think I'll try to do that. I haven't seen St. Louis play that much, but I guess if anybody was going to pick in Canada, they'd say Brett Hull. But, Janney or Shanahan could do it too.
Gary, we thank you for joining us. Always good to see you, and hopefully we'll see you in St. Louis again soon.
Well, thank you, Bruce. I've been down there a few times lately, and it's always good to get back.
That's Gary Sabourin, former winger with the St. Louis Blues. We thank him for joining us. Ken, Joe, you're getting closer to singing.
Yes, we are. We're going to sing Happy Birthday to you in the next intermission. We hope we don't sing Happy Birthday, and we hope, like Gary Sabourin, with our hearts with the Blues, that the Blues will be flying home tonight with an overtime victory here. But again, after a lot of whistles early in that overtime period, again, like Monday night in the first overtime, there were a lot of good scoring opportunities for both sides. Bill Berg had a splendid chance for Toronto.
Yeah, he really had a good chance. It was set up by Peter Zezel carrying the puck over the blue line. Now he's going to drop the pass, but look at both Blues defensemen backing up. Osborne has a lot of time, spots Berg, who gets away from Emerson, and he tries to tip it in, and again, Curtis Joseph, a spectacular save.
Then Wendell Clark, very dangerous situation created.
Yeah, he just throws it at the net. Now Joseph makes a save, but it deflects off Bob Bassin and goes right into the crease. A very alert play by Jeff Brown before McIlwain can get there and poke it into the empty net.
And the Blues had some chances of their own. Bob Bassin, a rebound. He couldn't get a stick on the puck.
Yeah, Miller will end up taking the shot. Bassin goes to the net, but an outstanding defensive play by Lafay. He takes Bassin all the way and just lifts his stick just before Bassin can jump on that rebound and get a shot off.
And the summary in the first overtime, no scoring. The Blues coming on, out shooting Toronto 10-8. Blues seem to get a little better of the play as that overtime period went on. One of the things I think we noted without any question, unlike the first overtime on Monday night, I thought play at times got rather chippy here, and I guess that's familiarity.
Yeah. You knew it was coming, didn't you? I mean, with these two teams going at it, they're both fatigued, and referee Paul Stewart more or less decided a long time ago that he wasn't going to give either team a power play. So they've been getting away with, you know, a lot of things, not only behind the play, but in front of the play.
And of course the Blues had only one power play chance in the first three periods, and to look back, Toronto's goal came on a power play. So we're 1-1. We're ready for the second overtime, the fifth period of the game at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. The Blues and the Leafs are tied at one. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Tom, and then give me, if you can, give me a shot of Emerson or Emerson on one side and Zezel on the other. Welcome back to Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. We're getting set for overtime number two. Joe Micheletti, Ken Wilson, and Bruce Affleck with you. As we get set for this overtime period, you know, Ken, if you look at these two teams and what's gone on tonight, Nelson Emerson seems to be a player with a great deal of energy for the Blues, and he's already had 10 shots on goal tonight for the Blues. On the other side, though, a player like Peter Zezel has been very, very dangerous and very effective. So those are two players to keep our eyes on here as this second overtime period should begin.
Boy, there's nothing like this. If this isn't fun, I don't know what is, to go to double overtime, back-to-back games to begin the Norris Division Finals. Of course, you start to leaf through the record books for both teams when you get into a situation like this. A lot of interesting stories unfold as you move into a second overtime.
And you would certainly have to think that the Blues would have a slight advantage because of their 8 days of rest. But this Toronto team just simply doesn't give up.
Now Hedekin shoots the puck in from the center faceoff. Ellard and Wilson battle in the corner in the Toronto end. Ron Wilson gets the puck to Hull behind the net. Hull centers. Lowry alone, he shoots. Great save, Potvin! 13 seconds in, Potvin stops Lowry alone. Look out, here comes Gilmore, but it's offside. The Leafs are offside at the St. Louis blue line, and Dave Lowry, who had a number of good opportunities in overtime in game one, had the chance of a lifetime right there.
Well, the Blues dumped it in, and Ron Wilson made a good play behind the net to Brett Hull. Now Lowry is all alone in front as Lafave leaves the front of the net, and Lowry right on the doorstep. Potvin had come to the left, and then he moved over to the right to make an outstanding save on David Lowry. But what a pass from Brett Hull. Lowry tried to take his time, and Potvin just lunged over to the right side of the net and made the save on Dave Lowry.
Boy, the coaches, it's got to be tough to stand behind the bench. First minute of the second overtime.
Zezalon with Osborne and Bird for Toronto. McCowan on defense shoots it in. He's teamed with Rouse. It comes to the right point. Rouse a blast. Oh, and a stick save. Joseph left point. McCowan a shot. Joseph another save. Loose puck in the blue zone. Wilson, or I should say Brown, gets the puck to Emerson. Back to Brown. Jeff Brown gets the puck into the Toronto zone. Osborne shoots it out, and here's Nelson Emerson losing the puck to Osborne. Osborne over the line to Berg. Berg to Osborne, and he can't get a shot as Emerson is all over him. Zezel trying to center Berg out in front alone. Now behind the net, Bill Berg tied up by Brown. Zezel gets the puck, tries to center, and he's unable to. Then Brown in the corner, a nice play. Janney gets a stick in the face. And Brown trying to get the puck out and does. Emerson picks it up. Emerson shoots the puck in from the red line. A minute 15 gone in the second overtime. Toronto to center ice. McCowan, oh, he's drilled down from behind by Rich Sutter, who gets the puck ahead to Miller. He's slammed down by McAway. Now Basson trip. Here's Rich Sutter along the boards in the corner to Miller. He's unable to center, and he's tied up by Gill. Jamie McCowan run down by Rich Sutter. He gets back up. Oh, and he's sent reeling by Basson. Now Miller to Rich Sutter, and he can't get a shot. And he hits the back of the net trying to center. Basson trying to work in front, and he's checked by Todd Gill. Then Miller intercepts to Basson. In front, Rich Sutter is level. Now Miller behind the net. Comes in front, a shot, the save by Potvin. He's picking up his stick. He lost his gold stick. And Potvin holds on in the Blues checking line of Basson, Miller, and Rich Sutter doing everything but scoring there.
Well, some great work by that line. A lot of cross-checking and hooking going on. Miller's going to end up making a good move behind the net. Now, he has a lot of time, but he's right on top of Felix Potvin, and that's where Potvin is his best, because he's back in the net, but when you're that close, it's tough to get a good angle and to get the puck up high. A great move by Miller, eludes two Toronto players. Potvin, without a stick, is reaching and still keeping his eye on the puck at the same time, and by getting his stick, he actually deflected the shot by Miller, and then it deflected up into his chest. Boy, we've seen some hitting. McIlwain on Kevin Miller. Both teams really going at one another.
Now the Leafs force the puck out of their zone. Lefebvre shooting at the length of the ice. Hennekin back to touch it. And that is an icing call against Toronto. From the Blues side, this is the ninth time in their history they've played a double overtime game. They have won six times and lost twice. And of course, the most recent loss, Bob Berry remembers well, it was in game one, a double overtime loss here Monday night.
Well, Pat Byrne says it was more difficult on his goaltender, Felix Potvin, in game one because he didn't face as many shots and he had to keep mentally sharp. 58-38, the shots in favor of Toronto.
Face off in the Toronto zone. Andrejczyk hounded by Hull, but Lefebvre covers up behind the Leafs net. He's on defense with Ellick. Gilmore is up front with Borchevsky and Andrejczyk. Very dangerous trio for Toronto. The puck down the ice, there'll be no icing. Here is Zombo driving the puck up to Hull. He can't get it out. Gilmore steals. Gilmore centers and Wilson intercepts. Then the puck chopped in the corner by Borchevsky. And Zombo for the Blues. Can't get it out. Andrejczyk centers right to goaltender Curtis Joseph. He gloves the puck and a whistle stops play. 1-1 the score. We're coming up to the 3-minute mark of the second overtime.
Well, and Curtis Joseph, after coming up with that loose puck, he'll look behind him. Zombo had control of it and couldn't clear it. And then Toronto will end up with a play. Doug Gilmore tries to set up one of his teammates. Zombo still has control of it, tries to clear it. It's knocked down by Gilmore. Now the puck will roll to the net, and watch, right behind Joseph on the play is Doug Gilmore.
17-19 to go, overtime period two. In the first period, Brett Hull scored for the Blues. Doug Gilmore tied it on a power play goal for Toronto. Now the faceoff to Curtis Joseph's right. Shanahan against Zezel. Zezel on with Pearson and Osborne. McCowan and Rouse. Here's the puck to Pearson. And a shot wide. Janney on the far side with a puck. And he sends it to center ice. McCowan for Toronto to Rouse. The veteran smashes it in. Near board, Zezel lets it go. So does Pearson, and Emerson breaks out to Janney with Shanahan over the line. Janney. Janney around everyone to Emerson. Tip it a tip. Brown scores on the rebound. Emerson stopped by Podvan, and Jeff Brown, the Blues all-star defenseman, scores on the rebound, and the Blues at 3:03 of the second overtime period defeat the Toronto Maple Leafs to tie this exciting Norris Division final series at a victory aside. And they congratulate, and well they should, the Blues outstanding goaltender Curtis Joseph.
Well, Toronto had trouble handling the puck in the blue zone, and Brown, you can see from the middle of the net, just takes off, and Janney will end up making a great play on Bob Rouse and feed Emerson. Brown anticipates the play all the way, a great save by Potvin, and then Brown goes up high over the glove of Potvin to put in the game winner and tie this series at one game apiece.
Oh, baby, what a sight. Emerson stopped on the feed from Janney, and Brown bags his second playoff goal. Emerson and Janney assisting, 3:03 of the second overtime period, and now game three set for Friday night in St. Louis.
Well, what a play by Janney beating Rouse on the play, and Brown just fighting through everyone, anticipating, waiting to see where that puck would end up. And he was right there to bang home the winner.
Boy, everybody thought this could turn out to be a sensational Norris Division final series. Two evenly matched defensive-oriented teams expected to play close, low-scoring games. And each of the first two games here at Maple Leaf Gardens end up 2-1 in double overtime. The Blues out shooting Toronto in the second overtime period, 4-2. The shots for the night, Toronto 58. And the Blues 40. Brett Hull and Jeff Brown score for the Blues. Doug Gilmore for Toronto. And hallelujah, the Blues win it 2-1 in double overtime here in Toronto. We'll be right back with more. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
Hi, Tommy. You guys got lucky not having to sing. What do you think, Tommy? Got a picture of Dougie's girl. Obviously, we know what it is. What were the final shots?